OHL Championship Series. Owen Sound, Mississauga. Game one.
There's your first of the series. The chance scores! They're starting to pour it on now. Mississauga has a 1-0 lead.
Game two.
Shot to the front of the net, scores! It scored!
Mississauga St. Michael's Majors will enjoy a 2-0 lead.
Three.
He's on a breakaway, scores!
Great with a steal.
It's over!
Owen Sound with a gutsy, determined effort on the road.
Four.
His shot, Anderson scores! Series is even.
Tonight, one team has the opportunity to send the other to the brink of elimination. Game five begins.
Brace to Halmo, scores!
On his own, Kinsen scores!
We're going to the OHL final.
It's been a fun ride.
And the celebration begins. History in the making.
The Majors have sealed the deal. They are the Eastern Conference champions in the Ontario Hockey League.
5 decades since this happened, folks.
It's a brand new series, Game 5 between the Majors and Attack, coming up next on Rogers TV. Welcome inside the Hershey Center, everybody. I am Ben Ennis. Game 5 of the Rogers OHL Championship Series between the Mississauga St. Michael's Majors and Owen Sound Attack coming up next. The Majors just rolling through the playoffs heading into this series. They'd only lost once in the previous three series, and then they won the first two games of this against the Owen Sound Attack, outscoring Owen Sound 11-4 over those first two games. Since then, though, a complete reversal of fortune as the Attack winning a couple of games in dramatic fashion in overtime. And maybe you can say the difference has been goaltending for the Attack, because the Majors offense just has not really gotten it done the last couple of games. Michael Zadar took over in net for Scott Stager after he lost the first two games, and then in game three, Zadar made 32 saves, picking up the 6-5 overtime win as Matt Petgrave scored the OT winner. 41 saves for Zadar in game four in a 2-1 win. The Majors, a lot of shots on goal, but a lot of shots were blocked as well. And offensively, things just not going the way the Majors would hope they would have gone, because they scored 16 goals over the first three games of this series. And then, of course, on Sunday afternoon, only one goal against Michael Zadar. The first game in the series, Majors haven't scored a power play goal. And the Majors, you have to go all the way back to February 16th for the last time they lost two straight games. It's been a long time for the Mississauga St. Michael's Majors. For the Owen Sound Attack, well, they are rolling right now, and the Majors just don't know how to stop them. Defensively, a couple of breakdowns for the Mississauga St. Michael's Majors, especially in game three. Three breakaways for the Attack in that game. They scored twice on them, and that was obviously huge because that game went to overtime. Then in game four, in the extra frame, Cameron Brace, he also scored on a breakaway. So the Owen Sound Attack really doing things very well offensively. They scored 8 goals over the last two games. JP Anderson not at fault for all of those games, but Majors need to tighten things up defensively heading into this game number five. For more, let's send it downstairs to Alicia Warner.
Thanks, Ben. The Majors trying to avoid doing something they've done only once all season long. That's lose 3 successive games in a row. Of course, those 2 overtime losses they suffered in games 3 and 4 were the only losses in overtime for the Majors so far this season. A slight lineup change for the Majors in game 4. Greg Such replaced Derek Schoenmakers in the lineup. Such will be the case again tonight as well. For now, we'll send it to the ice level for the national anthem.
Cause we hunt you down with adversity. Hunt you down all night long. Feel I breathe upon your face. Feel I breathe.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, at this time we ask you to please rise and remove your hats and join Michelle Giacometti in the singing of our national anthem.
Oh, Canada, our home and native land, true patriot love in all our sons command. With glowing hearts we see thee rise, the true North strong and free. From far
and the Owen Sound Attack did a lot of work to get back into this series. In fact, they had to work overtime, not once, but twice. But are they ever back in this series? As the Owen Sound Attack and the Mississauga St. Michael's Majors get ready for round five, if you like, of the Rogers Ontario Hockey League Championship Series. I'm Roger Lajoie, Matt Scooby. We're in the broadcast booth. Ben Ennis, Alicia Warner, and our great Rogers TV crew welcome you into the OHL final as the puck is fired into Majors territory. Anderson puts it all on the board. Smith-Pelly takes his man, then moves the puck up. Nice pass for Cizikas. Cizikas in for Shug. He winds, fires over the top of Zadora's glove. Cleared back out to center. Brace now with it for Owen Sound. One-on-one against Percy, backhand, and Anderson with the save. He'll smother it and hold on, and pretty good end-to-end action as we're underway in game five of the OHL Championship Series presented by Rogers.
It's goaltender number one versus goaltender number two so far in the playoffs. J.P. Anderson gets a start for Mississauga. Number two in goals against Savage behind Michael Zadora, the Owen Sound Attack, who is at the other end of the ice. But Anderson bent a little bit, had a good solid performance last game in game number four. Unfortunately, his team came out at the wrong end of the stick. Really, at this point, Owen Sound want to fire a lot of pucks towards that blocker side. Maybe a little bit of a weakness right now for the Mississauga goaltender.
Cutting with the shot. Anderson blockered that one out. Flick gets it up to Brace, and Brace is at center. Brace in over the blue line. Clears it in. Here's Flick's side of the net. That shot stopped by Zador. Another backhand attempt right in front. Squirts loose into Sousa. Couldn't get a stick on it. Back to Canton at the point. Deflected just wide. Felis will move it up. He takes a hit as he does. Cleared to center. Played back by Flick. Up to Canton. Canton now for the Majors. Fires it in. Pass Zador into the corner. Cutting. Plays it up along the boards. Cleared back in the Majors territory, and Parente is back. Hi to everybody watching tonight in the OHL Action Pack throughout Ontario in the eastern part of the United States. Great to have you with us. As the OHL Final Series tied at two. Both these teams going to the Memorial Cup. But you think this Final Series is anticlimactic? Think again. Who doesn't want the OHL title and the J. Ross Robertson Trophy? Owen Sound, first time in the final. Majors in the first time in the final in the modern era. Shaw now tips it in for Owen Sound. Into the corner. Hit against the boards. Berdnikoff takes a hit, and Maxim Kitson will pick it up for the Majors. Kitson gets it ahead for Mayer. Mayer tried to bring it in. Partnan back in the corner for Mayer. Mayer, he stops in the corner. Such goes after it. Such tries to pick it up. Wraparound attempt by Mayer is stopped. Chance for Wise. Mayer again with a shot. That's over the top of the goal. Shaw is just going to relieve the pressure and fire it into Majors territory. Anderson will let it go by him. He'll get the icing call. Some pressure for the Majors in the early going. 2:09 into this opening period.
Owen Sound has to do a much better job of being defensively responsible in front of their goaltender. Michael Zadora right there. Been very limited. 4 wins in 6 games played. Came in relief a couple of times. But the important thing is that he's gotten it done in the win column, especially in this final series. He's 2-0. 6-5 win in the 2-1 overtime win in last game in game number 4.
Look at that. Goals against average of 1.80. How's that for a postseason GAA? Blacker brings it in for Owen Sound. Tries to cut around Fleming. Fleming ties him up. And the Majors gobble that puck up and bring it up. Cramarosa at center. He'll shoot it in. Flicked into the far corner. Gilbert is back. Wise is chasing him. Here's Gilbert now for Owen Sound. Gets in over the blue line. Shug took it away from him. Shug brings it in. Shug face-off circle. His shot off a stick, off a glass. Cleared into the corner. Majors battle for it there. Kishin tries to move it up. He can't. Finally, it's cleared to center and played back deep by Fleming. Fleming and Percy. Smith-Pelly brings it in. Little backhand, weak one, stopped by Zador. Rebound in front. That also stopped by Zador. Cizikas is knocked down, and the attack will play it behind their own net. Cleared to center. This has been a tale of two series almost. Majors winning handily in games 1 and 2, 5-2 and 6-2. And then two dramatic overtime wins for Owen Sound. 6-5 here in Mississauga, 2-1 at home. Cizikas brings it in. Back behind the goal, wrap around, that stop. Smith-Pelly behind the net, we got a penalty coming to Owen Sound behind the play. Stannis is on top of his man. Owen Sound's cutting will now touch it. And we'll have our first power play at 3:34 of this opening period.
It's going to be a hooking call going against Owen Sound. Maybe even interference, but it's going to go against Stanis, who's caught up behind the play. Kind of got hooked. He puts his hands up on his way to the box. But again, just the stick comes level. As we see on the replay, the stick will come level just a little bit late there. But the stick came level with the defender coming back. So Mississauga dangerous on the power play, ranked 3rd in the playoffs. Don't want to give the Owen Sound attack. Have done this before, and the Mississauga scored 3 power play goals in the first period of game 1.
D'Orazio puts it back for Fleming now. Fleming for D'Orazio. D'Orazio for Fleming. Face-off circle. Takes a step back. Fleming back for D'Orazio. D'Orazio for Fleming. Puts it through Mayer. A little too far for him. Owen Sound recovers, and it's cleared out. Watch the breakaway pass. We've seen this, but just fails to connect as McNarney was sprung away. Owen Sound has done that several times. Caught the Majors in deep. Seen 4 or 5 breakaways, including one shorthanded that turned into a goal last time in here.
Very unlike Majors hockey.
Now along the boards, Mayer for Cramarosa. Canton for D'Orazio. D'Orazio fires way wide. Flick can't control the rebound. Gets a stick on it, then loses it. And it's cleared up, and here comes Owen Sound again. Short-handed. Wilson brought it in, but content to let it go with still 1:02 of power play kill for Owen Sound to do. Flick brings it in. Flick's shot goes wide. Smith-Pelly along the boards. He can't control. Percy tries to pinch in. Better be careful here. Hishin and Flick are back after it, but it's Flick that beats him to it. And he'll gobble it up. Flick back for Smith-Pelly. Flick's been out there for a long time. Finally makes a change. Here's Shug down the left side. Shug lost it. Taken by Helas, and Helas brings it in. Weak shot steered out by Anderson. Played back, and Cizikas will take it. Casey Cizikas at the blue line. At center, fires it in. Zadora watches it go all the way back to center, and Canton has to play it there. With just 18 seconds left in this power play. Has not been a great one so far for the Majors. Shug tried to move it ahead. Tipped back in. That's pretty much going to do it for this extra man situation. As Canton goes back, penalty will expire. And cutting pops out of the box. So first kill for Owen Sound, and a good one. Cramarosa up for Wise. Wise will shoot it in. Zador leaves it, intercepted, but that quick pass in front by Such went nowhere. Back the other way. Wise tried to control it. and offside at the Majors' blue line. So after some early pressure and an early power play for the Majors, nothing to show for it. We're 5:54 into this period.
Another look at this short, another shorthanded possible chance. And as Raj, as you mentioned, a couple of chances. We've seen this happen. It really was a turning point back in game one of the shorthanded breakaway that the attack got and that McNardy was able to capitalize on. So the Majors have to be very wary, but give credit to the attack for taking off when they see those opportunities. Spoke to Coach Mark Reeves before the game, and he said that's on his players. They recognized opportunities and took advantage.
Cramarosa and the tippet ahead. Wise puts it into the corner. Cramarosa is after it. With the attack, we'll move it up. Petgrave, pass. That's off a stick. Parente lost it. Shoulderly shot. Anderson stopped that. Close call there is in deep for the attack. Smith tries to play it along the boards. Tries to move it up. He's bumped. Third right back in, and D'Orazio goes back after it. Things have settled down a little bit here as both these teams realize what's at stake. You can't win the series tonight, you can't lose it, but boy, you can certainly take a stranglehold on it. Game five. It's down to a best of three. Quick wrap around a tip. There's an Ors down in front. Scores! Flick! Went to the net, found the loose puck. Zador couldn't control. And the Majors draw first blood.
Rob Flick has been one of the best players for this Mississauga team through this OHL Championship Series. And to give him a lot of credit, a lot of sloppy play, though, especially defensively by both teams here in the early going. This time, another big turnover on a good forecheck. Puck just squirts free. Zador can't find it. He tries to sit on it very awkwardly from Michael Zador. But again, the defensive turnover is what set that up. A very good forecheck. Flick, opportune moment, pokes it in. Early lead for Mississauga.
Cleared in by DeMello, and Zador, bad break there. He just couldn't control that puck. Squirted past him, and Flick, I'm sure his eyes were wide when he saw that puck loose in the crease. Managed to get a stick on it and put it in. 6:57, time of the goal. The Majors have the 1-0 lead. But Owen Sound, they've answered back in this series, haven't they? Cleared in by Maidens, intercepted by the Majors, and away comes D'Souza. D'Souza lost it again to Maidens. Cleared in, Canton is back, and he'll take it for Mississauga. Mark Canton, he's got the Memorial Cup pedigree. Been in this tournament. Won. As has Justin Chug. As Kitson moved it ahead, but Maidens took it from him. Helas now for Owen Sound. They're in unfamiliar territory in the OHL final, but that ends after you get a couple of wins. You get back in the series. Another penalty coming Owen Sound as DeMello was knocked down. Mayer now at center, a little bonus power play time as Anderson goes to the bench, but it's going to be touched by Petgrave right away. We'll have another whistle, and we'll have another Mississauga power play at 8:03.
The attack cannot continue to do this. They did it in game one, and they cost them three goals. They were fortunate enough to stay in it, but this time I believe it's going to be a hitting from behind penalty against the attack. It's going to go to Helas. So again, second penalty, we are not even halfway through this first period. Yes, the Majors didn't capitalize on that first power play, but if you're gonna give them opportunities, it's going to come, as you see. Just a dangerous hit, and that hit cannot happen. Happens right in front of the official. Helas didn't slow up. He put his man right into the boards from behind.
Face-off control by the Majors on the power play. Zizika's face-off circle. Back for Percy. Percy for Canton. Canton has a look. Far boards, Percy in for Zizika's. He couldn't control, but corrals it right back. Zizikas along the boards for Canton. Canton for Zizikas. He winds, he fires off a stick, off a mesh. Hit the glass first and then the mesh. Might have hit an Owen Sound player, and it did, so the faceoff remains in attack territory.
It's interesting to see the adjustments, that both coaches have been making on the power play on the special teams. We saw it in the early going that Dave Cameron went to his high player, to Devontae Smith-Pelly, to be up in the slot, and then now Stuart Percy has moved in to just try to confuse that rotation, but it looks like Mark Reeves has adjusted his penalty kill as well to counteract that rotation and to counteract that high man in the slot.
Majors win the draw. Back to Percy at the point, over for Canton. Canton takes two steps, puts it in, and a big stop there by Zador. Smith-Pelly directed that towards the Owen Sound goal, and Hishon will clear it all the way down to Anderson. Bounces into him, he takes no chances. Wilson's parked in front of him, so he'll smother it and hold on, but Zador had to be sharp there. Smith-Pelly, Matt, just got the stick on it, and had a good shot.
And as soon as I say that, you know, you see the kind of the adjustment that Smith-Pelly was open there as you take a look at both head coaches. Interesting to note, too, that this series has gone so back and forth that one team will score early, the other team will respond, and so forth and back and forth, even maybe not even early in the game. Last game, we saw it in the third period. So, again, look for Owen Sound to come back and get another goal. They are not going to do that, are not going to be very successful if they keep taking penalties, however.
Rangers on their second power play, 108 left in it. Here's Zizekas ahead for Shug. Shug over the line. Shug brings it in. First scores! Justin Shug on the power play at 9:01. And the Rangers strike again. It's 2-0.
The attack lacking some energy and another lazy play. Here we go. It looks like Scott Stager is going over to get his goaltending equipment, as that's two goals on six shots for Michael Zadore. I think Stager is going to be coming into this hockey game. But again, look at the lazy play at the blue line. Backing way up, caught way out of position. Shug with a pretty weak shot. Again, that's one you know that Michael Zadore wants to have back, as Shug just got it away. Didn't look like it was deflected, and we will have a goaltending change.
Well, the margin of error in an OHL final is very, very small as we see the goal. And Mark Reitz did not waste any time. 9:01 in after just six shots faced. Michael Zadore in for Scott Stager, who played games 1 and 2 in this series. Let's give Mark Reitz credit for one thing. He is not afraid to make the goaltending changes. He brought in Zadore, and a lot of people looked funny when that happened after the first two games. And I'm sure there'll be some wondering about this one, but Zadore was not sharp on either goal. And as I said, there's no fooling around time. This is the best of three now, as DeSousa's punched into the boards by Cutting. Played up off the boards. Kept in by Flick. Gets it for Fleming. Fleming now takes a step. Face off circle. Fleming in the corner behind for Brace. Brace behind the net. Centered in front, and nobody there but white shirts. Wilson now up for Brace. Brace down the right side. Cameron Brace, the overtime hero. Sunday slips it in front, but cleared by Fleming, and a penalty coming here. Another one to Owen Sound. Thought it was a Majors call, but it's not. Brace brings it in. Takes a step back to the point. Not touched by Owen Sound, but no possession. Majors still have another bonus power play here with Anderson on the bench again. Flick, though, better be careful with the puck in front of his own net. Flick takes it back a step. That goes off his skate. That's what happens when you've got an empty net there, boys. You see that went off his skate. Better just let him touch a puck. And finally, Owen Sound Shaw will do that. Matt, the Majors played the last OHL game in North Bay. And during that game, North Bay scored on their own net with the goaltender out. Major fans, veteran fans will remember that.
A little bit of a scary moment as the puck came off his skate there. This is going to be an interesting call, and if we get another look at it, because it looked like it was the Majors forecheck on the back check that was got tied up with the Owen Sound forward, and you really couldn't I didn't really see it was behind the play. As we take a look at the players going to that at the top of your screen. Oh, and it was a hook on, I believe, that on the attacks that Hischen going towards the net. It looks like Hischen got his stick tied up. Wouldn't be surprised if we saw coincidentals, but I think it's only going to be one. The Owen Sound penalty box is open.
No, it's definitely only one, because Anderson was on the bench for a long time, and Dave Cameron is taking the advantage of the timeout here to do some preaching at the bench, and Owen Sound penalty box open. Mark Reitz is shrugging the arms, wondering what the deal is.
As you take a look at the goaltenders as well, Zadore came in, got two big wins for the attacking games 3 and 4, but it did not have a good start tonight. And I think this is more of a goaltending change as well for Mark Reed's team. Reed just needs to get his team going. They've been they're not moving their feet in their defensive zone. They've had very little offensive pressure as well, but they have a big penalty to kill here to start to the middle of this first period as well.
And some pressure for sure on Scott Stager, who played games 1 and 2, as we said. And a important penalty kill for Owen Sound. Do not want to get any further behind. Canton keeps it in. Pass Shug. Zizekas will pick it up in the corner. Back to the point for Percy. Percy cross ice for Canton. Canton for Percy. Percy in the corner for Zizekas. Zizekas back for Canton. Side for Shug. Shug fires right in to Stager, and he'll hold on with Smith-Pelly parked in front, and Smith-Pelly gets a couple of pushes from the Owen Sound defense.
Another good rotation, another couple of good passes, and again, don't want to keep saying it, but Owen Sound just looks slow. We haven't seen them, especially in the past two games. They've come out quick. They've come out hard. They've brought it to the majors physically and offensively, and they just look a step behind so far.
Canton fires it wide. Shug picks it up. Lost it, and it's cleared by Owen Sound all the way back into Mississauga territory. 125 to go in the power play, 8:55 to go in this opening period. Mississauga on its third power play of the period. As Smith-Pelly comes down the right side. He skates in. Shug went to the net. Blacker got a stick on it. Shug behind the net for Zizekas. Puts it back for Canton. Canton at the point. Has a look for Shug. Shug takes a step. Face-off circle in deep. Smith-Pelly in front. Backhand by Zizekas. That stopped. Zizekas another whack. And both times stopped by Stager. Shug gets it back. Somehow keeps it in. But Helis clears it. And then Shug brought it back in. So we'll have the offside.
Good first play by Justin Shug to keep it in the line, just couldn't hold it. Again, we had the Owen Sound attack have had a couple of good game fives in this playoffs. It was first in the first round against the London Knights. They came out one game five, 6-0. And then in the last round in the Western Conference Finals, game five against Windsor, came out one 10-4. So they're going to need a lot more offense to get back into this game five as well.
Didn't need a game five in the second round, Matt. And you're right about that. The majors not used to playing deep into series either. They were 12-1. Mississauga was 12-1 through the first three rounds. Owen Sound 12-3. So neither of these teams really has the playoff fatigue you sometimes see deep into a playoff run because of their success. 25 seconds in the power play. Mayer for D'Orazio, but Flick will play it on the boards. Flick in deep. Kitson now in the corner. Kitson uses that big stick and reach. Looks for some room, puts it back for D'Orazio. For Fleming, 10 seconds in the power play. D'Orazio fires through a crowd, that's why. Kitson with a rebound, scores!
Maxim Kitson! Backhanded from a tough angle. There was all kinds of traffic in front of Stager. I think he thinks that it went off a high stick. We'll see if they'll check it, but it's 3-0 on the power play for Mississauga.
Shades of game one here in the Hershey Center. As Max Kitson from a bad angle, as you said it, Raj, that was a really bad angle. I think Stager was more concerned that he was interfered with, more so than anything else. As Mark Reeves on the bench, you take another look. It looks like Jordan Mayer in front of the net. You can't, it's out of your screen there, but Kitson, again, put the puck towards the net. That's 3 goals on 10 shots here to start the first period. Majors power play clicking again.
Maxim Kitson, 9th goal of the postseason. Team Russia, World Junior standout, gold medal winner. Broke the hearts, helped one of the guys, broke the hearts of Canadian junior hockey fans at the Worlds, but making the fans in Mississauga feel pretty good this postseason. He's been a big contributor. That's a big power play goal. So now the attack. Need to answer back quickly as Petgrave puts it in the corner. Framarosa for the majors, brought it in front of his own net dangerously. Brace lets it roll out to center. Played back deep by the attack, pass cutting. Brace will pick it up, puts it back for DeMello, and DeMello will shoot it in. Stager plays it behind the net. Gives it away. Framarosa tried to move it, couldn't, and the attack will try to come away. That bouncing puck is going nowhere at the moment except center ice. Now Brace clears it back. Anderson tips it away for DeMello. J.P. Anderson has played every minute of every playoff game this postseason. As DeMello plays it for Canton. Canton back for DeMello. Ahead for D'Souza, he tips it in. Cleared, and Stager had problems with that. Childerly will play it up. Steered in by Smith. Anderson put in the corner. Smith still with it. Some nice aggressive skating there. That forces a giveaway. And the majors take it away, though, as Zweep couldn't play it. Kitson comes right back again off the side of the goal. Back to the point. Majors with all the life now. D'Orazio shoots it in. Kitson again with that big stick and reach. So it makes him so dangerous back behind the net. He's a big, tall guy to start with, and that stick looks sometimes, Matt, twice as big as anybody else's out there for some reason.
It's kind of crazy to watch him play, and it has such good hands with and such good movement with that stick as well. It really is, as a forward, really very skilled.
Cleared in by St. Mike's. Owen Sound moves it up. McNardy now. Lost it, though. Backhand wise for Cramarosa, his shot. And Stager with a good play to keep his goal stick down on that one. Fleming tries to keep it in. Can't. Cramarosa backhands it to the corner. Wise played it up, but taken by Helas. Helas at center, shoots it in. Far corner. Maidens tried to pick it up, couldn't. Such is back there. He takes a hit, kicks it ahead. Still can't clear the zone. Cramarosa tries to move it up. Can't. And the Majors finally worm it out to center, and Cramarosa will tip it ahead, and they'll make changes. Back in their own zone is Helas. 5 minutes to go here in this opening period. Mississauga 3, Owen Sound nothing in game 5 of the OHL Championship Series presented by Rogers. Cleared back in, and of course you're watching Rogers TV tonight as Anderson puts it ahead. DeMello, long pass for Shug. Shug will backhand it in. Stannis for Jesse Blacker. Blacker up off the boards, past Canton. Winds up at center, but DeMello was alert to be back. Cizikas brought it in, but that's going to be offside. The blue line will have the face-off there with 4:32 remaining in the opening period.
As Max Kitson, we talked a little bit about that stick, but has he been a contributor for the Majors this postseason? That goal, the past goal, 9 goals, 9 assists, 18 points, leads this team, but also it's a 6 power play goal. So really contributing on special teams as well. He's been quite the pickup, as you know, you can't really talk about him enough, Raj, after he played for Russia at the World Juniors, as he mentioned as well, and really a big-time player. Majors are happy to have experience like that heading into the Memorial Cup.
Brace now brings it in. Brace back in front, and Christian couldn't pick it up. Chipped ahead. Here come the Majors. Cizikas 2-on-1 with Smith-Pelly. Cizikas brings it in. Fires Smith-Pelly with a rebound. Scores! Devante Smith-Pelly! 2-on-1 is deadly for the Majors, and it's 4-0.
A great play by Casey Cizikas, and if you're going to keep and shoot on a 2-on-1, this is where you have to shoot. Far side, cross ice, he knows he has Smith-Pelly with him, and this is just a really smart hockey play. Cizikas down the wing, opposite pad, rebound is there. Great set of hands by Smith-Pelly to get the backhand. It was a little bit of an awkward angle for him. He had to bring his stick very close into his body, but he got it up over the stick of the diving Stager. What to do now for Mark Reeds?
Yes, already made the goaltending change if you're just joining us. So 2-6 and 2-7. That's the save percentage. Majors have 13 shots, 4 goals. Not much of a difference as Percy takes it back deep. Brings it up for Flick. He steers it in. Clear it all the way back down. Anderson will get his stick on it. Put it for Percy behind the net. He'll rim it along the boards for D'Souza. Kept in. Corrente avoids the check, moves it across, and Percy gets it up. This series has been a tough one to figure out. Two relatively easy major wins in games 1 and 2. Two great overtime wins for Owen Sound. And a huge start so far tonight for Mississauga, but it's been back and forth. They may go back and forth tonight yet, as that shot is stopped by Anderson. And nice work by Petgrave to get in, create that chance. Weird bounce, Mayer couldn't move it up. Majors have had trouble clearing the puck out of their own zone at times in this series, and Helas takes it behind the net. Centers in front. Back for Blacker at the point. His shot deflected, scores! That's answering back. Deflection in front at 17:06 as the Majors were hemmed in their own zone, couldn't clear it out, and they paid the price.
This puck was tipped in front, deflected in front. Again, as you said, Raj, paid the price. It's been the defensive lapses that both teams haven't been able to get the puck out of their zone that have cost them a couple of goals. This time, it's the Majors as the shot comes from the point. Believe this goes off Maidens in front. Possibly on a couple of deflections as well, but the Majors get caught with 5 guys below the hash marks. Nobody out to pressure the point, and just the puck towards the net takes a deflection, and a big goal for Owen Sound as they get on the score sheet here in the first period.
17:06, time of the goal. Then they come again. Burdnikov tried to, but now Cizikas back the other way. Cizikas dumps it into the corner, tries to get around Blacker. Cizikas behind the net, tries a wraparound, stopped in front, whacked at, but cleared by the attack. McNardy puts it up into Majors territory. Anderson comes out to play it. Boy, that's what I mean by the Majors. You see that passing play. So many times they've been unable on that first pass. One of the strengths of the Majors has been one pass out of their zone, taking some chances in deep. Nice forechecking by Owen Sound led to that goal after Majors failed to clear. Another chance in front. Whacked at, and Anderson with the save. DeMello can't clear. And now Canton will gobble it up for the Majors. Canton down the left side, shoots it in. Rimmed along the boards. Brace picks it up there. Puts it back for Flick. Takes a hit, backhand in the goal, in the Owen Sound territory in the corner. Hishon avoids a hit, makes a nice move to bring it up. Joey Hishon at center. Little back pass, streaking down. Petrave in front, trickles through, and Anderson almost lost that one in front. Flick back for the Majors. Said this series was back and forth. This momentum going a little back and forth here as Owen Sound gets some light with that goal. Flick will slap it into the corner. Long pass, nice one. Brought in by Wilson. Wilson gets it in, and a shot, a good one. But Anderson was right there. Fishing at Wilson again with it. Cleared back to the point. Kept in by Gilbert, shot is stopped. And again, pressure with Brace with it. Brace in the corner. Battles, digging at it. Four-man scrum, look at these individual battles. Eh? The OHL Championship Series, that puck. Finally, Wilson saw it dart out. Was right there, right place, right time. Centered in front, big chance, scores! Cutting, and the Majors cannot clear the puck, and it's 4-2.
Almost speechless right now about how you're supposed to determine which way this series is going to go, because after four goals in the last 4 minutes, the attack finally gets some offensive pressure. The Majors can't get it out of their zone again. A puck comes through the crease and just on the doorstep to fire it home was Cutting. Again, good work down low, move the puck around, good forecheck. Wilson with a centering pass. He's been relatively unheard of so far as Garrett Wilson, but he got a good pass. Just got the puck through the net. Cutting made no mistake.
Majors are losing those one-on-one battles in their own zone the last couple of minutes, and we said before the game, we got a series, we got a game again, as the Majors, as they have in this series, have taken an advantage and handed it right back, much to the displeasure of that man, Dave Cameron, who looks tight-lipped, to say the least, behind the bench.
Interesting note, in the latter part of that period, the Owen Sound attack went 4 minutes without a shot on goal, and J.P. Anderson now have two goals in the last 4.5 minutes.
Shot off the glove is a door, and boy, or a stager rather, and he had to be careful again as Smith Pelly whacked that one out of the air. Dangerous opportunity there. Smith Pelly just darted in after the puck went off Zadora's glove and swatted at it. Another face-off in Owen Sound territory. Attack win that. Stannis takes it back behind the goal. Blacker. He can fly. Jesse Blacker's at center over the blue line. Blacker brings it in. Haul down. Majors go in the penalty box. And it's starting to unravel here for St. Mike's.
You said that Blacker can fly, and that's exactly what caused that penalty. Smith Pelly not moving his feet at his own blue line. Reaches out with his stick and hauls Blacker down. And things are kind of coming apart. I think it's a good thing for Dave Cameron and his hockey club. There's only 16.3 seconds left in this period. As we'll take another look at the penalty, Blacker cutting to the outside. Smith Pelly, you can't stick your hand in there. You have to let him go by at that point when you're that far out of position and not moving your feet.
Hooking the call, the Smith Pelly. Fleming can't get it out. Here's Blacker. Takes a step. Shot. Stopped by Anderson from Hishon. Cleared to the corner. 7 seconds in the period. Wise is going to be able to take it out. He does to center. Pass up for Flick. Flick fires it, loses his stick, and gets knocked down to boot. And the period will end. And if I had said the period will end mercifully for Owen Sound about 10 minutes ago, you might have said, yeah, for sure. Now maybe the period ends mercifully for the Majors after they take a 4-0 lead. Matt, they give up two goals and still a significant power play time left here in this period.
Really is fitting at this point. As you know, go back and forth. Majors win the first two games. Owen Sound comes back and win the next two. Majors score the first four goals in this game. Owen Sound with two, and they're going to start the second on the power play.
Back and forth they go, both in the game and in the series. Game five of the Rogers OHL Championship Series. Majors lead 4-2 after one. Let's go down to the panel and get the thoughts led by Ben Ennis.
Thank you very much, Rog. The Majors on top of the Owen Sound attack 4-2. Ben Ennis joined by Peter Curtis. Peter, this series just gets crazier by the moment. This is the first game, though, that the first period hasn't been tied after 20 minutes, but Majors in complete control at 4-0, and then two goals late in the period for the Owen Sound attack.
Well, right now, you know Coach Dave Cameron in Mississauga's dressing room is probably losing it in his own way. Sloppy hockey from a team up by four goals late in the first. Something happened on that bench. They relaxed for a bit, and now they find themselves with just a two-goal lead.
Majors, the first game in the series without a power play goal, that coming in game four in Owen Sound. They have two in the first period, and it looks like they're back to what made this power play very effective in the first couple of games of the series.
Well, here's a series where we've had 14 out of the 31 goals scored on the power play. So what should coaches be telling? Don't take any penalties, but this Mississauga power play, very potent. But we've also been watching, Ben, yourself, pointing out that the defensemen have been giving up a lot of opportunities to these Owen Sound penalty killers, almost that shorthanded threat every time Mississauga has a power play.
Robbie McNardy has the most goals in the OHL playoffs so far. He plays for the Owen Sound attack. He's downstairs with Alicia Warner.
Thanks, Ben. The Majors power play continues to be effective for them tonight, but you guys bounce back with a couple of your own, and now you're going to go to your own power play in the second. Your thoughts on the first?
Well, we were sleeping basically first 10 minutes. Penalty kill was not great, but at least we're back in it now. We kind of woke up a little bit, got our feet moving, starting to hit guys, but we were happy at least we're sort of back in the game.
This has been your first playoff experience since your first year in the league with Kingston. What's the ride been like so far this year?
Oh, it's been amazing. I mean, such a great group of guys that I want to win with, and it's been a great year overall, and this playoffs have been really special for me, especially, and I'm just loving it right now.
It's pretty unique for you too, being a Richmond Hill native, you know, not only going to the OHL final, but to the Memorial Cup with so many friends and family close by. Talk about what that means for you in your final year of junior.
It's been absolutely amazing. I mean, I got some big signs here, and all my family's here. I have like 20 people here a game, even in Owen Sound as well, and they've been supporting me basically my whole career. And it's been great this last couple months.
You've been on over a point per game pace throughout the season, throughout this postseason. 14 goals leads the postseason in 19 games. So what do you have to do personally to get your team back in it and close this gap of two goals?
Well, basically just keep playing hard. I mean, keep getting to the net. That's where all the goals are. I mean, just try to bang them in, what I've been doing.
Robbie McNardy of the Owen Sound attack, who trailed the Mississauga St. Michael's Majors 4-2 here in the first intermission. Join us for more after the break, where we have game notes. This is Rogers OHL Championship Series on Rogers.
Hi, I'm Bobby Gillespie, president of the Owen Sound Rotary Club. I'm here to thank our Owen Sound Attack Challenge sponsors. Their contributions make Rotary projects a reality.
Looking to get your sports fix? Join our panel each week for RTV Sports Wrap.
As we dive into sports topics with in-depth discussion, predictions, and opinions.
Local, provincial, national, world sports. We cover it all.
Everything you want to know that is happening in the world of sports.
Sports and more sports. It's all right here on RTV Sports Wrap, only on Rogers TV.
Stand up stronger. I got the power, gonna raise it.
The show is about to begin.
Back of the net.
you got to pick your moments. When it comes time to be on the ice, that's the only thing on your mind, and that's when you're on the ice in practice, you're trying to get better.
Welcome back. The Mississauga St. Michael's Rangers on top of the Owen Sound Attacks, 4-2 through 20 minutes of Game 5 of the Rogers OHL Championship Series. I am Ben Ennis, joined by Peter Curtis. And Peter, there's a ton to talk about after that opening 20 minutes. There's a ton to talk about after seemingly every period of this entire series. So much intrigue. But I guess the number one point to talk about is Michael Zadore getting the hook after allowing the first two goals of this hockey game. Two goals on six shots. In comes Scott Stager, his second appearance in the series, started the first two games of the series with a... Now, Jordan Binnington is the odd man out today, and it's been... all three of these goaltenders have been scratched at one point in this series, but Stager gets back in the net. He doesn't look particularly sharp, but it seems like that was sort of the jumping off point for the attack to get those two goals late in the period.
Well, the Zadore, the first goal that gave up, it was Gilbert dumping the puck behind his own net, leaving his defense partner and the goalie out to lunch right there. The second goal, you know what, it was a wrist shot, but it was a tough one. It was a right-handed shot skating into the middle of the ice surface and taking a wrist shot. He just didn't know where it was going to go. Stager, did they really take off once Stager got in right there? It was 4-0 before they decided to score, but in these playoffs, like you said, Ben, anything goes when it comes to putting goalies in, taking them out. And right now, Owen Sound can at least say, hey, we got our number one goalie from game two in there. Now we have a chance to win, even though the number one goalie from game three is sitting on the bench.
All right, maybe they didn't jump off right from that point. Maybe it was a little delayed because they allowed those two goals and then scored the two late ones. The Majors, a couple of power play goals. They were 2-for-3 on the power play. And the Majors in this series have been great with the man advantage, 38% heading into this game. And that just obviously goes up with the 2-for-3 on the man advantage for the Majors in the opening period. You talked about it a little bit before we went to break there. Dave Cameron can't be too pleased with the way his club is playing on the defensive end. Couple of pucks didn't get out of the zone when they probably could have, one leading directly to a goal, and that's got to be a point of emphasis you've got to think for Dave Cameron going forward.
Well, Owen Sound actually changed that approach. It seemed every time they were scored on, they put that fourth line up with Sweep, Smith, and Childerly, and they went out and they were physical on this Mississauga defense corps. And we've seen the Mississauga defensemen, there isn't one small guy in their top six of D, but for some reason that fourth line for Owen Sound, they instilled a little fear in those Mississauga defensemen, and you saw the puck didn't get out, and Owen Sound scores two goals at the end of the first.
One thing I talked about off the top of this broadcast was the number of odd man breaks and breakaways in general for the Owen Sound attack in the first four games of this series. They had three of them in game three alone, scored a couple of times. Seems like that is a point of emphasis for them on the breakout, not just five on five, but shorthanded as well. Seems like they're always sending somebody up the middle, try and get that quick long lead pass.
Well, when we look at the statistics, we're always big concern about height, weight, goals and assists, but what you don't see is a column about speed. And what we've seen with McNardy, with Wilson, with Shaw, these guys can skate. I know why Hishon was drafted in the NHL by Colorado for being such a small guy. He's got a great speed. He's got that extra gear. And right now, Mississauga needs to know, as soon as Owen Sound's D gets the puck, they need to be skating backwards because there's always a forward going down the ice.
Got to be skating both ways in this game, and both teams flying right now through 20 minutes of play. Brad and Will have the rest of the news from around the CHL.
Yeah, Will Parkinson and myself here to update you on what's happening around the Canadian Hockey League. Starting out west, the WHL continues their championship series. The Portland Winterhawks and the Kootenai Ice. It is a 1-1 series. The Ice earned a split in Portland for their first two games. So they're in Cranbrook, BC, where the Ice play for game number 3, 9 p.m. Eastern. And we'll, of course, be tracking that game when it gets underway at the 9 o'clock hour. In the meantime, though, we have the OHL draft to look back on. That took place on Saturday. We had a little preview on Friday night during our game 3 broadcast, and now we can look at what went down. And Will Farquharson's been slaving away on the draft pages. We know what happened with that first pick. It was Aaron Ekblad, and of course he stands out because he's so young.
Yeah, Aaron Ekblad did go first overall, like the Barry Colts announced they would on Friday. He's a 15-year-old defenseman. Now, he's the second player to be drafted as a 15-year-old under the exceptional player rule, the first being John Tavares. So we'll see how he plays in the OHL as a year younger than everyone else, but he does have the potential to live up to be a Chris Pronger type, but we'll see how he fares as a 15-year-old in a league with some older kids playing.
Meanwhile, seven picks later, of course, we see that fairly famous in the GTA and elsewhere Domi name get off the board.
Yeah, Ty Domi's son Max is drafted eighth overall by the Kingston Frontenacs. Dougie Gilmore, the GM of that team, so the first pick he makes
as
GM.
Bit of irony almost there.
Yeah, Gilmore drafts Domi. So it'll be interesting to see how Domi plays just down the 401 in Kingston in his first year in the OHL. He started with the Don Mills Flyers.
And those Flyers from Don Mills, two representatives in the top eight. The number three pick was Darnell Nurse.
And the interesting thing about Darnell Nurse is that he is the nephew of one Donovan McNabb, the Philadelphia Eagles quarterback.
Athletic,
so that's some
genes.
Interesting athletic genes for sure.
So there you go. That's a look at some of the main names. We'll take a look at the Majors pick as well as the Owen Sound Attacks pick and, of course, the QMJHL and plenty more when we talk to you at the second intermission. But that's it for us at the first intermission.
Thanks a lot, guys. The Majors and Attack heading into the second period. Game five, always crucial when the series is all tied up at two games apiece. And this, no exception. Peter, time for one quick final thought before we head into the second. The pressure, I think, was back on the Majors now heading into this game with the series tied up at twos. But the Owen Sound Attack maybe relieving some of the pressure on themselves with those two quick goals at the end of the period.
Well, right now, the number one line with Wilson, Hischen, Embrace, the new number one line, they haven't been a factor in this game. They're only down by two after falling back by four. Gives Owen Sound a little bit of hope to say, hey, let's go for it in their building, see what we can do in this period.
The second period coming up, the Mississauga St. Michael's Majors trying to take a 3-2 lead on the Owen Sound Attack. They lead it 4-2.
Hi, I'm Bobby Gillespie, president of the Owen Sound Rotary Club. I'm here to thank our Owen Sound Attack Challenge sponsors. Their contributions make Rotary projects a reality.
It's hard to believe it's been 10 years since the Owen Sound Attack shocked the junior hockey world by winning the Ontario Hockey League Championship. But get ready to relive that moment on Rogers TV. Join me, Manny Pava, as I host a special edition of Attack Wrap with members of that 2011 championship team. It will air after the rebroadcast of all seven games of the 2011 OHL Final from May 9th to 15th.
Are you a woman experiencing abuse? Do you know a woman experiencing abuse? Help is available any time of day or night. ShelterSafe.ca is an online map that helps you find a women's shelter or transition house that meets your needs so you can live a life free from violence. ShelterSafe.ca. Help is just a click away.
I get sued for doing the same thing my family's been doing for hundreds of years.
We're going to lose the farm.
We're going to the Supreme Court.
If you win, no farmer could ever be sued for saving his seeds again.
Since when did we start locking people up without a trial in this country?
I'm going to make him pay.
He has been held against his will for 6 years without a single charge being laid against him.
I am innocent.
Second period, seconds away from getting underway. Roger Lajoie, Matt Scooby in the broadcast booth. You're watching the Rogers Ontario Hockey League Championship Series. Game five from the Hershey Center tonight. Mississauga leads Owen Sound 4-2, but 1:44, still a power play time for the Attack to start this period now.
Just saying to you, Roger, before we came on, lots of shots in that first period, 16-14 in favor of the Attack, and again, they'll look to capitalize on this early power play.
The attack looked like they were going to be out of this one early. Four goals before the 16-minute mark for the majors, but two late ones by the attack as they answered back in this game the same way they've answered back in this series. And they start this period on the power play. Stannis deflects it into majors territory. Fleming battles him behind the net. Percy rims it up along the boards, kept in though by Blacker. Blacker takes a step back to the blue line and out. So Stannis has to go back to his own blue line. Majors penalty kill has been very good in the postseason. Needs to be good here. They gave up that power play goal in the later stages of the third period that tied the game Sunday. Owen Sound had a power play goal in the opening period. Here they come. Blacker tries to move it. He lost it. Nice play by Canton to take it from him, or Wise rather. Look at Wise with a nice poke check. Killing precious time on this penalty kill. Still with it. And four white shirts finally surround him, take the puck away, but it's down to 30 seconds in the power play. Hishin over the blue line. Hishin forced deep into the corner. Canton will pick it up, find a hole, and off a Majors player, knocking in Owen Sound territory. Stager will leave it. And the attack move it up. 10 seconds in the power play. Last rush. Petgrave comes down the left side. He doesn't need much time. Petgrave in the corner. Looks for room. Puts it in the far corner for Shaw. Shaw bothered by D'Souza. Penalty is over. Out pops Smith Pelly out of the box. He's got a chance at this puck. Tries to catch up with it. Couldn't. Runs into Stager. Just a collision. And Halmo gives him a bit of a shot. But credit to everybody there. They just move on. Inadvertent collision. They're going for the puck. And no harm done. Now you're seeing the discipline of these two teams. They realize, hey, this is game five of the OHL final here. This is no time to be getting silly, even if it's a play like that. Now here's a play like this from Mayer. Kitson is alone in front and can't catch up with it. He's knocked down. Puck still loose and goes over the top of the goal. Owen Sound shot the puck past their own net there. Kitson had gotten a stick on that. There was trouble. Kitson with a shot. That's high and wide. Scored from the weird angle last time. Takes another chance now. Mayer rims it along the boards. Corrente will keep it in. Corrente in the corner. Off Kitson's stick. Battling for it is Mayer. Mayer wins that battle. Puts it back to the point to Corrente for D'Orazio. D'Orazio puts it in deep. Cutting, couldn't pick it up. Mayer will take it. He falls. Corrente keeps it alive and finally cleared out by Cutting. Shaw now back the other way. His shot stopped by Anderson. Rebound. Another save by Anderson with a glove and with Halmo in front. Corrente gives him a shove and lets him know don't get too close to the goaltender, please.
But
3-0-4 gone in the period.
Yeah, sorry, Roger, you mentioned also as well the discipline of that of both of those teams not to take anything, especially on that chance for Smith-Pelly. He's taking another good flip. Just tried to get it, Smith-Pelly. Just know where he can go. Doesn't lower the shoulder, tries to slow up. And then at the other end of the ice, another chance. Anderson with a couple of, maybe a little bit of a rebound. At the other end, Stasia had a little bit of trouble corralling a puck as well. We saw Zidore give up the first goal in this game after having trouble corralling a puck. A
lot I liked about that play as Stannis' shot goes wide. First, Smith-Pelly did try to avoid him. Stager was good about it. Halmo gave him a little bit of a shot just to let him know, look, he hit the goaltender, and Smith-Pelly went ahead. That's the way to play the game.
Especially in the playoffs. There's no room for stupid penalties. Owen Sound can't afford to take any more penalties at this point after taking three in the first period, two of which Mississauga capitalized. But Halmo lets him know he's there. Just kind of just gives him a little shot. Yeah, again, I agree, Raj, that I like the play. And they've moved on, and now they're just worried, concerned about playing hockey.
Faceoff will be right at center ice as the puck was knocked into the Majors bench. Majors win it, and DeMello puts it back for Canton. Over for DeMello. DeMello makes the move, shoots it in. In pursuit is Brace, but Stager came in, took that puck off the boards. Brace, though, will pick it up. Tries to put it back to the point, taken by D'Souza, and a big glove save there by Stager as D'Souza flicked that wrist shot in, but Scott Stager good with the glove.
Seen it so many times from Chris D'Souza, that quick shot. Scored a goal earlier in the playoffs from just a little bit higher at the top of the circle off his back leg as well, but just in on his stick, finds it, and lets it go very quickly. D'Souza, great shot, but even better saved by Stager at that point. Maybe going just a little bit wide as well.
Darted out the glove nonetheless and cleared back up. Here's Halmo. Palmo now down. Shot is blocked. And it's taken away by Wise. Jamie Wise for the majors. Shoots it in. Picked up from the Peterborough Petes early in the season. Been a big addition to this team. Plays a gritty two-way role, but Halmo comes the other way for Owen Sound. His pass off Bernagov's stick. Played back for D'Orazio. He took a hit, but still got it up to Cramarosa and for Greg Such. Such at center, tips it in. Feel the tension in this building. Early second period. Mississauga up 4-2 in the game, up even in the series, 2-2. As Percy picks it up. And this game, like the series, started all Mississauga and is tightened up as the puck goes off the glass there. Played in behind the goal. Shug for Smith-Pelly. Smith-Pelly bothered. Still with it. Puts it back in the corner. Shug comes after it. Sweep is there. He's trying to move it. Stannis will dig it out. Petgrave battling for it. Now Owen Sound running around their own zone. Finally, Petgrave will fire it all the way into majors territory and he'll get an icing call. 5 minutes even now into the second period. J.P. Anderson in the majors up by two.
Not a bad play by Petgrave on that play either. This will relieve some pressure. Ring it around the boards. The rule doesn't apply in the OHL that when you ice the puck, you can't make a change. So when you feel offensive pressure like that, a good job by the majors' first line as they stay out on the ice. Dave Cameron rewards them with some ice time after a good forecheck. Relieve some pressure. Get a faceoff in your defensive zone.
Face off in Owen Sound territory. Game six in this series in that wonderful town of Owen Sound on Thursday night, where they're embracing the attack as they always do. The Harry Lumley Bayshore Community Center will be rocking again for game six, boy. Rogers Television will bring you that game with the great Rogers TV crew out in Owen Sound on Thursday night. Puts it back in for Shug. Shug steers it towards the crease, and Stager got a piece of that. Shug again. Tries to find some room in the corner. Back to the point for Fleming. Fleming, shot to a crowd, deflected wide. Shug picks it up. This majors line dominating right now. Cizikas in the corner for Shug. Shug, shot is blocked, and away comes Owen Sound. Burst of speed, Brace comes down. Brace has Wilson with him. Shot is wide. Comes back to the far side. Hishin keeps it in. Oh, look at Wilson! That shot blocked. Boy, Wilson got a gift there. Again, the majors don't clear. They get a second opportunity here, and now they do. Mayer brings it out to center, over the blue line for Kitson. Kitson tries to work his way in. Cutting knocks him down. And cleared right back out into majors territory all the way down the ice. And that will be another icing. And the faceoff goes into Owen Sound territory.
At this point, a good shift, but maybe just a touch too long for the majors' first line. They dominated in the offensive zone, but almost got caught coming back as Justin Shug was caught out there and caught a little bit out of position. But a good play by Cutting. I like the play Cutting made down in the defensive zone, taking Kitson off the puck. Not an easy thing to do, taking Max Kitson off the puck like he did, but another good defensive play from the attack.
DeMello at the point. D'Souza, shot stopped. Rebound in front, flick, shot stopped, and a big save by Stager there as there was a lot of traffic in front. Brayson Cutting push in front, but another face-off.
The majors doing a much better job of not shooting the puck, at the chest of the attack goaltender. Right now it's Stager, it has been Zador in the past two games, but getting some rebounds, getting the puck towards that blocker, towards the glove, down at the pads. We saw the third goal that Smith-Pelly scored. A shot away from the pads that gave up a rebound. Zador really struggled with that in the game number one, and Stager's given up a few here as well, but again, not just at the chest and no rebound, no second chance opportunities for them. They've had plenty tonight.
Mayer takes a step back. Bernadov tries to hit Shaw, who was streaking in behind the majors' defense. The attack have tried that several times in this series. Sneak a man through, and they've had several breakaways as a result. Kitson, though, corrals it in the corner. Puts it back to the point. Canton for DeMello. DeMello in the corner for Partnan. Mika Partnan lost it, and Shaw picks it up. Shaw back pass for Halmo. Halmo now at center. And that's offside at the blue line. Of a face-off back outside the blue line. If a seventh game is necessary in this series, it's at the Hershey Center Sunday afternoon at 2 o'clock. And the Hershey Center is the site of the MasterCard Memorial Cup, May 20th to 29th. You can buy individual game tickets, packages still available at Ticketmaster.ca.
Ice conditions look good considering the weather we've had. Not too hot here in Toronto today as well, but so far the ice is holding up very well. A lot of shout out goes out to the ice staff and all the staff here at the Hershey Center to do a good, great job of keeping up this ice.
Going to have to keep it warm at the end of May, too, with the Memorial Cup tournament on the way as D'Souza moves it ahead. Both the attack and the majors will be in that tournament, and they will meet Wednesday, May 25th, regardless of who wins this series. Wednesday, May 25th. There will be a rematch of the OHL final at the MasterCard Memorial Cup. A lot of hockey still, though, to be played. At least two games and quite possibly three as the attack bring it up. Helas tries to pick it up. Fleming hit him as he tried to clear it, but going to whistle that down, bring the faceoff back outside the blue line. The attack don't like the call.
A very close call, but I think it was the right one by the linesman on the play as he explains it to Helas, who was upset about the call, but just puck just kind of got chopped out, went off his skate and went back in. As again, kind of died. We saw this, I think, maybe in the first part of the first period as well, at the first 5 or 6 minutes at this point, that not a lot going on. Both teams, again, kind of just a little bit of energy lapse. Majors dominating the play so far. But as we've seen throughout the course of this series, things can change very quickly.
Here's Smith-Pelly down the right side now with a break. Smith-Pelly brings it all the way in, fires, big save, rebound, and cleared by Smith. Smith-Pelly gloved that ahead to him, raced down. Save made and the rebound cleared. Kept in though by Corrente. His shot is blocked. D'Orazio, last man back, better be careful, but avoids Smith and keeps it alive for the majors. Now Shug brings it in on the blue line. Smith-Pelly again in deep. Smith-Pelly fires and, oh boy, Scott Stacher looked around but had that puck trapped in his body and he will hold on.
Kind of had a look back, just a quick look back there. So we'll take a look at those both previous major chances. That's now 20 shots on goal for Mississauga. Smith-Pelly, great speed as he got the puck towards up, or got the puck to himself, and a good save by Stasier. A little bit of a rebound again. Good job defensively to tie it up. And Smith-Pelly again, as this first line for the majors is really dominating in the attack zone.
Well, Dave Cameron, without question, although he makes a change here finally, has shortened that bench a little bit. Smith-Pelly, Cizikas, and Shug, you see them skating off, are getting much more ice time than they have at certain points in this season, but hey, it's the OHL final. Wilson for Brace. Hischen brings it in. Hischen, forced behind the goal, still with it. Hischen puts it back to the point. Kept alive, here's Petgrave. Centered off a stick. Majors get a chance to clear, and Such will do it. Such at center, avoids a hit. Gets it ahead to Wise. Wise tips it ahead. Such finishes his check. Cramarosa goes after it. Centered off a skate all the way back into majors territory. Anderson's going to have to come out and play it as Wilson is skating down. And Anderson content to dump it to center. Petgrave, though, brings it right back in. But a step offside with Shaw. Brace looks at the linesman. It wasn't Brace who was offside. It was Shaw.
I think it might have been. And maybe even at the bench in front of the Owen Sound bench. Again, those gates right on the blue line. And that's where the linesman looked like he was looking. Look where he pointed after. He has a conversation with Shaw. Just offside.
Gilbert slips it in. Parton in there to play it for the majors to DeMello. And DeMello gets it up for Kitson. Kitson for Mayer. Mayer tries to dart in. Can't. Both Cutting and Gilbert got back. Here's Halmo at center. Off his stick. Cleared back up to center. Mayer blows a tire, cleared back, and Gilbert goes after it. Giveaway here, Jordan Mayer picks it up. He can't get much on that shot. Kitson takes it into the corner. He's pushed off the puck. DeMello, we got a penalty coming to the majors. Shaw brings it in. Little bonus power play time. Shot stopped by Anderson. Majors still haven't touched it. Now they do, and at 9:50 of this second period, a power play opportunity coming to Owen Center.
One of the incidental high sticks is DeMello just kind of clipped the attack forward. Looked like it was a high stick. That's what the penalty is going to be for. DeMello doesn't like it. It's a couple words for the official as he goes off the ice. But
regardless, it's Owen Sound's turn as we approach the halfway mark of this second period.
So another important penalty kill, aren't they all, at this stage of the playoffs and stage of the game. Shug tries to break away but can't, just pass a little too far for him. He's got to get back now, though. Estanis tried to clear it, but Fleming will play it up to Percy, and Shug will tip it in. Stager comes out, plays it behind the net. The attack now trying to get it going. It is high sticking. Stannis up the left side, shoots it in. Anderson stops it. Is he going to play it? Yes, he will. Up for Shug. Shug gloves it and then clears the zone. Wise goes after it. Can he get around Blacker? Wise does have it. Gets a weak shot off, goes to the corner, and played back on the far side by Stannis. Hishon, pass for McNardy. Canton will intercept and clear the zone. Cramarosa with some juice now. Goes all the way into the corner, beats Stannis to the puck. Blacker takes him into the boards. Look at this work by Cramarosa in deep. Kills a few more seconds. Now the attack come back the other way. Back pass, Hishon. Too far for him, that could be icing. No, icing is waved off, D'Orazio. He'll play it for Canton. Canton tries to clear it off the boards and it trickles to the blue line and out. Yes, the linesman blows the whistle. It is an offside. 50 seconds remain in the Owen Sound power play.
This Owen Sound power play, 6 so far in the playoffs, clicking at 22.5%. They have the most opportunities. They've had 111 advantages so far, and that's way more than anybody else at this point. Granted, they've played the most games. As they are in the game 5 of the OHL Finals, but only in 6th spot.
Shaw brings it in deep. Power play continues for Owen Sound. Back for Petgrave. Far point. Petgrave. Shot by Shaw, and that hits something in front. Weird bounce. Bernadov gets it in front. Slips to Anderson. Canton tries to clear. Puts it in the corner. 27 seconds in the power play. Owen Sound still controlling down low. Shaw. Bernikov. Face-off circle. He's looking around. Back for Petgrave at the point. 15 seconds in the power play. Fakes a shot. Puts it in deep. Trickles to the point and over the blue line. Petgrave forced back to his own blue line. One more rush perhaps for Petgrave. Here he comes. Petgrave going to bring it in himself. Had it taken off his stick. Out of the box comes DeMello. Team's back to even strength, but Petgrave has it. And that shot hit a stick and went to the far corner. So a successful penalty kill for the Majors. Halmo picks it up. Some of the Owen Sound fans wanted a penalty call on that play. Halmo still along the boards, tipped away nicely by Brace all the way into Owen Sound territory. A little pushing and shoving behind and cutting his back to play it. 7:45 to go in the second period. Game 5 of the Rogers OHL Championship Series. Series tied 2-2. Majors lead 4-2 tonight. Brace a back pass to the point. Kept in. Here's Cutting. Cutting now, shot, that's off of Cizikas' ankle. He'll put it back behind the goal and Fleming will play it there. Now the Majors showing a little bit more poise. Their own end of the rink. They were running around a bit at the end of that first period in their own end. Not the case here in period two as Gilbert shovels it to the corner for Cutting. Smith-Pelly's in the corner, centered in front, and Cizikas couldn't catch up with that, but Brace does. He's got speed. We saw it in the overtime in game 4. Brace along the boards now, stops, waits for his team to catch up, puts it in for Helas. Helas tries to control, Cizikas takes it from him, but gave it away again to Brace. Back for Gilbert. Gilbert puts it in off a stick. Saw this on the last Owen Sound goal, their control in Majors territory, but this time, Percy will move it up to Smith-Pelly and they'll clear it. Cizikas dumps it in. Line change time for the Majors. Attack play it back in their own zone. Gilbert turns around, Mayer almost took it from him. Now does take it from him, goes into the corner. Cramarosa after it. Mayer back for Flick. Shot blocked. Taken and the attack might ice here, but Corrente got his glove on it to stop that. Owen Sound forward line was out there for a long time. They're still trying to get a change, and now they do as Stannis plays it up to Maidens, and it's tipped in. DeMello in his own zone. Up on for Flick, for Mayer. Mayer with a nifty move of the blue line. Finds some room. Mayer tries to go in deep in the corner, still with it. Puts it in the corner for Flick. Flick turns, fires, deflected in front. Another shot by Cramarosa. Stager with the save. He'll hold on. 5:54 to go. Wayne Simmons is in the building, and he's in conversation now with our Alicia Warner.
Thanks, Raj. Wayne Simmons with me of the Los Angeles Kings, right winger. home for the summer, taking in some hockey, but I understand you kind of had a little bit of an allegiance to the Owen Sound Attack. You played there for a year and a half in your OHL career. Tell us about that.
Yeah, definitely. I started in Owen Sound, and it was a great place for me to be. I started my career there, and it's great to see the Attack here. It's good for the community. You know, I'm sure everyone's going crazy in Owen Sound.
Now, we were discussing a little bit, waiting for that lengthy play without a whistle, what you're going to be doing for the rest of the offseason, whether you're going to be going back to L.A. or staying here. So maybe tell us a little bit about that, your training regimen.
I live in Scarborough, so I kind of just stay in Scarborough for the whole summer. Probably go back to L.A. for a couple weeks. You know, it's summertime's not bad there, so I'll be there for a bit.
Tough life this guy has, guys. Wayne Simmons, back up to you.
And Wayne Simmons with his allegiance to Owen Sound, and why not, of course, with a great time there. Dave Cameron is a fan of Owen Sound, too. He tells me that all the time, but Maddie's not too thrilled about going back there for Game 6 if they don't hang on to this lead here tonight.
It would be a tough one to go back, Roger. Again, 4-goal lead in the first period. They were sloppy at the end of that first period, the last four and a half minutes. But again, like you said, they kind of picked it up here in the second, and I'd love to go to L.A., too, as well.
Wouldn't be bad to spend a couple of weeks there anytime. You got that right. It's better in the winter than it is in the summer. L.A.'s a little hot in the summer. I've been there for the NBA Finals. There's a shot by Shug off the side of the net. Might have got a piece of the post. Blacker tries to play it up. Cleared ahead and a little too far for Wilson. Fleming goes back. He'll shoot it in. That's going to be icing. And we'll have a face-off in Majors territory. 5:31 to go in the second period. Mississauga 4, Owen Sound 2. Game 5 of the Rockies OHL Championship Series.
Another look at that chance from Shug. Top of the circle. Looks like he wired it off the crossbar, the way that puck bounced and came out. But regardless, you can't say enough about Justin Shug, OHL Player of the Week. Has a goal in every game of this OHL Finals so far.
Wilson shot is stopped by Anderson. You want to win the OHL Player of the Week anytime, but boy, when you're winning it in the last week of the season, yeah, that one means a little more for sure. Especially there's only two teams playing. Slapped in by Fleming. Stannis goes back after it now. Stannis behind the Owen Sound goal. Forced back by the forechecking of Devontae Smith-Pelle. Up for Wilson. Wilson finds some room at center. Brings it into Majors territory. Wilson carries it in. Fleming swatted it to the corner. Cizikas will pick it up there. Play it off the glass. That's a smart play. Coaches love that. As Stannis goes back. And here's Hishon. Joey Hishon's a smart player too at his own blue line. Cizikas is on top of him right now. Knocks him down. Majors try to clear it. Canton gives it to Fleming. Fleming at center. He'll shoot it in. Takes a weird bounce. Goes into the corner. Blacker goes after it. And it's the Attack with a long pass. That's how the Attack have tried to counter this, as we have an offside, the blue line. How the Attack have tried to counter this tenacious Majors forechecking you're seeing in the second period, Matt. More often than not, the best way to do it is use the speed, maybe create a scoring opportunity or a long pass, and they continue to employ that strategy.
It looks like it has been the strategy for this point, and again, another attempt at it there, the stretch pass, trying to utilize the speed that they do have at this point. And another battle between Flick, a lot of little pushing and shoving, a lot of jarring going on so far.
Clear it in, braces after it in the corner. Flick bumped off the puck. He'll try to move it. The Attack, or the team moving it now, as Halmo has it in his own zone. Trying to find some room is Halmo. He'll shoot it in. Anderson tried to play it. Majors try to clear it. One chance, two chance, still not out. Now DeMello will get a third chance, and he will tip it out. You watch teams that are good defensively and teams that are not good defensively. Watch how many attempts it takes to clear the puck out of their own zone. That is such an integral part of the Major success when it's working. Tipped ahead. It's working in this period as D'Souza tried to bring it in. Halmo meets him in the corner, battling for it. Dave Cameron screaming for a line change. Oh, boy, and they get caught. 2-on-1. McNardy in deep. And the pass fails to connect. Now the other way the Majors come. Kitson, a 2-3-on-2 to Mayer in deep. Mayer, fire, save! Stager might not have seen that one, but he stopped it. Mayer now puts it back. Cramarosa back for Corrente. Corrente, shot deflected through a crowd. In skates and cutting will come away. cutting. Pass up for Halmo off his stick. Cleared back to the blue line, and D'Orazio, he'll play it for Corrente. Up ahead for Kitson. Kitson over the blue line. Kitson, pass for Cramarosa. His shot deflected in front, and Mayer directed that, and another big save by Stager. Kitson in the corner. He's battling. Burnikov is there. Who wins it? Squirts out to Mayer. Mayer still with it. Fires. That's wide. Good forechecking pressure here by the Majors. But finally, Maidens clears it out. Tipped ahead, and the Majors come right back. Cramarosa, though, lost it. Maidens again. He's alone. Brings it in. Tries to worm his way through. Squirts out, and Kitson is there to take it. Maxim Kitson for the Majors. Hits center. There at the end of a shift. You knew that. And Kitson clears it in, and the attack will go back at the Majors. Roll out five new blue shirts. Fleming tipped it ahead. Kept up by Cutting. Cutting ahead right into Anderson. He's going to smother it, and you don't take chances in game five of the OHL final with 1:57 to go in the second period.
A couple of big chances at both ends of the ice. As you heard Dave Cameron yelling for that line change, his team gets caught, and not the guy you want to send away is Robbie McNardy. In alone, had a good chance and went for the, tried to get it just out of the reach of his teammate. And then at the other end, it was Mayer, who had a great shot. Cramarosa got the puck towards the net, went off the leg of Mayer and just wide as well. But both players, both teams opened up just a little bit here in the second. Has been a lot of defensive hockey so far, but a couple of chances, big chances at each end of the rink.
Smith-Pelly fires it in. Shug in the corner. Back pass for Cizikas. Cizikas now for Fleming. Back behind for Smith-Pelly. Smith-Pelly tries to dart in front, but Blacker got a piece of that. Puts it to the corner and comes away with it. Owen Sound now comes out. Here's Stanis at center. Over the blue line. Stanis all the way into Majors territory. Around Fleming in front. A big save for Anderson. Boy, Stanis played Fleming well there. Kept him to the perimeter and managed to get that pass across, and Anderson had to make the big save. Fleming now puts it back for Percy. Percy puts it ahead for Shug. Little back pass, Smith-Pelly's at center. Smith-Pelly's over the blue line for Shug. Shug brings it in, backhand, stop, another shot. That's stopped as well, and Petgrave will pick up the rebound. Here's that breakaway pass again, and Hishin almost picked it up. Boy, the attack are just dining off that, aren't they?
Yeah, Hishin was standing at the blue line waiting for a pass. He wasn't even moving his feet. Majors defenders have got to be more aware.
Now here's a giveaway. Flick brings it in. 3-on-1. Flick brings it in, and Stager's the story in this period. He is keeping the attack in there with another big save.
Ralph Flick looks skyward after that chance, and it's too bad for him, but this is what we've seen a couple of times with the Majors getting shots on goal. They're going to hit the attack goaltender right in the middle of the chest. Watch where the shot goes. Right in the logo. He was trying to go underneath the blocker, but it hit him right in the middle of the chest. And not an opportune rebound, especially when you're on a 3-on-1 like that. But again, the attack trying to open it up, and it could be a bounce like that or one of those long lead stretch passes that could get them back into this hockey game.
Owen Sound wins the draw. Petgrave controls. Petgrave pass up off Halmo's stick into the corner. Canton. D'Souza tries to pick it up, still loose in the corner, shot it in front off the post! Another shot, Anderson smothers. Oh, glorious opportunity there for Owen Sound. And now you gotta be careful. You don't want that after the whistle penalty as we have a push and shove in front. Boy, the attack won that draw and took all 12 seconds to take the puck down the ice and just put it off the post.
Again, another defensive lapse at the end of a period as of what a great save. Anderson got a piece of it, and the puck went off the post. Also, we didn't talk about his save earlier as well, as you don't see too often that Brett Fleming gets caught. Words still being exchanged down there. Well, referees will sort out the penalty situation.
Well, we're going to have coincidental minors just as a result of that roughing. Referees waited as long as they could and finally have sent Shaw and DeMello both off. And now the talking is going to continue.
Petgrave and Wise continue to talk.
Wow, was that a close opportunity for Owen Sound. Off the post. Four aside, Jamie Wise came over from the Peterborough Petes. Wasn't playing much for the Petes at all. Comes to the Majors, going to play in a Memorial Cup at the end of the month. How about that? And is playing in game five of the OHL Championship Series as well. Big face off here. This one the majors win. Percy takes it behind his own net. Gets it for Smith Pelly, then up to Percy. Cizikas at center. He'll get turned around at center. Can't control. Wilson tried to move it ahead. Petgrave is back. Smith Pelly tried to get it past him. Petgrave takes a step in over the blue line. Petgrave has it. Quick shot. And Anderson had to make the save. And boy, the attacks certainly have been able to worm their way into majors territory. And we had some stick work there at the end of that period. See if anything's going to get called here.
Casey Cizikas is going to get called for a slash at the whistle as he also jars at Hishin. But again, for the second period in a row, the attacker going to start the period on the power play.
Wow, that is a costly penalty for Casey Cizikas to take if that is indeed the only call here. As both Sean DeMello are sent back, Cizikas comes over to plead his case, but it's probably going to fall on deaf ears, and that could be a turning point yet as the majors again, apparently, and we say apparently, are going to have some penalty kill work to do. 4-2 majors after two. Time to check in with the panel downstairs.
Thank you very much, Roger. I am Ben Ennis, joined alongside Michelle Storino and Peter Curtis with the Mississauga St. Michael's Majors still leading the Owen Sound attack 4-2 after 40 minutes of play. The story, without question, ladies and gents, was Scott Stager there in that second period. He was great after taking over, gave up a couple of goals in the first period, but great in that second period.
Absolutely. I think he tried to set the tone maybe for his teammates coming out and being aggressive and trying to play the puck, even outside his blue ice. But I don't really know if he set the tone because they couldn't really get out of their zone for majority of that second frame.
Well, he was calm, though, under pressure, and sometimes you don't get to see the quarterback aspect of that goalie coming in, being a good coach on the ice, helping settle down the defensemen and getting them through the tough periods.
And at the end of that period, Casey Cizikas is taking a penalty for slashing, so it looks like the Owen Sound attack are going to start the third period on the power play. That's always dangerous when you get the power play at the start of the period. You got the fresh ice, easy to make the passes in the offensive zone. And it will be a 5-on-4, despite the fact that they were playing 4-on-4 there at the end of the second period. Michael D'Orazio is downstairs with Alicia Warner.
Thank you, Ben. Michael D'Orazio with me here of the majors. Can you maybe tell us a little bit about that late penalty call and how that's going to affect you guys going into the third?
Yeah, definitely. We want to limit our penalties and limit their chances. But you know, I think it was a bit of a soft call. But at the same time, it's a big kill, and we'll go from there.
How do you guys prepare moving forward? I know it's a big momentum shift. You know, you're up 2-0 in a series, and then just like that, two quick overtime losses even it out. What's your mentality, the team's mentality, going into a best of three now?
I think, you know, we knew it was going to be hard. You know, it's not easy to win a championship. You know, we're expecting to go to 7 games from the start of the series, so we're not too surprised. You got a good Owen Sound team over there. I think if we stick to our game plan, we'll be fine.
Finally, after a crazy first period, you guys are still firing all cylinders on that power play. What was it like to have the game kind of slowed down, maybe more to your pace dictating in the second period?
Well, we knew, you know, they put us back on our heels at the end of the first period, and we wanted to come out in the second period and just play the way we started the first. And I think we did a good job of that, and, you know, we limited their chances, and, you know, we got pucks in deep, and I think we did well.
Michael D'Orazio of the Mississauga St. Michael's Majors, who lead the Owen Sound attack here in Game 5, 4-2 in the second intermission. Join us for more after the break with Game Notes. You're watching the Rogers OHL Championship Series.
Hi, I'm Bobby Gillespie, president of the Owen Sound Rotary Club. I'm here to thank our Owen Sound Attack Challenge sponsors. Their contributions make Rotary projects a reality.
Chandler is a savage with knockout power.
Let's go get that title.
Charles Oliveira.
The longest active win streak in the UFC.
This man is super dangerous.
I'm back. I'm here to fight.
Nate Diaz is one of the biggest superstars in the sport.
Leon Edwards is incredible. England's best hope for a UFC champion.
Sold out event. Here we come, Houston.
To work on your balance, but you're not sure how to start? Join me, Christina Marquis, on Homebodies Fitness. We'll work your balance, decrease your falls, and get you fit just in time for the winter. Only on Homebodies Fitness, Rogers TV.
October 5th, 2014, my daughter was hit by a train. She was walking along the sides of the tracks, and it shattered her world.
What kind of show do you want to see on Rogers TV? What interests you? Log on to RogersTV.com, fill out a show proposal, and tell us about your segment idea. We want to know what you want to see. Rogers TV, only on Rogers.
Takes a look out front, backhand pass, knocks it down again, scores! Oh my goodness! Johnny on the spot, and he started it all, so why not finish it? Pass to the far post, and a one-timer, and the puck finds the back of the net.
You got to pick your moments. When it comes time to be on the ice, that's the only thing on your mind, and that's when you're on the ice in practice, you're trying to get better.
Welcome back to Mississauga St. Michael's Majors on top of the Owen Sound attack, 4-2 through 40 minutes of play as we play game five. We don't, they do. Game five of the Rogers OHL Championship Series here on Rogers TV. I am Ben Ennis, joined by Michelle Storino and Peter Curtis, and we're going to dissect the first two periods of this hockey game. There's a lot to talk about in that first period. Michelle, you weren't here for it, at least on the panel.
No, I was.
But there was a lot to talk about. Just take my word for it. Okay. Peter and I did a lot of talking, and we're going to do a lot of talking here in the second intermission as well, but maybe not as much to talk about in that second period because it looked like the Majors were kind of back to their old defensive stylings, trying to limit the chances. A very good opportunity for the attack to score late in that second period, hitting the post as the save was made by J.P. Anderson. Puck went off the post. Shots are 26-25 in favor of the Majors, but this is a pretty even game so far in that second period. As mentioned, the Majors getting back a little bit to their defensive style.
Yeah, absolutely. Cizikas, Shug, and Smith-Pelly, you could definitely tell when the three of those guys are on the ice because they just control everything down low. Owen Sound has a really hard time getting out of their own zone, and you find themselves using the stretch pass a lot. This home run pass up through the middle, it didn't really work a lot of the time because Mississauga is clogging those lanes, but the one time it did work was with Garrett Wilson. Wilson having a semi two-on-one, he decided to pass instead of shoot, and then it was broken up. But so you see Owen Sound using different ways of hopefully trying to generate some offense, and I wonder how they're going to do it on the power play. As you mentioned, they have a 5-on-4 power play to start the third period. Peter?
Well, when you take a look at this Mississauga team, what you're really asking Mississauga to do is get deeper and force that defenseman before they can get the puck off the glass and hit that home run pass right now. McNardy's got amazing speed, and you see all five players on Mississauga, they're backing up the minute a defenseman on Owen Sound has the puck. It's time to go a little bit deeper, put a little bit of heat on these defensemen and make them pay a price.
Guys, Peter and I were talking first period about the fact that Dave Cameron likes to play his four lines no matter what the situation is, up 4-2. He hopes that that is going to be a positive thing for his club, that he's going to have fresh legs going deep into the playoffs, deep into hockey games. And I guess the third period would be a big indicator to see whether the Majors have the pressure of the legs of these two teams. And I'm sure Dave Cameron hoping that his team has a little more gas in the tank because he does roll four lines.
Well, absolutely. Just that second period alone, I mean, that's Dave Cameron's style of hockey, as you mentioned. And they were pretty much rolling as they usually do and as they did throughout the entire regular season and now throughout the playoffs. So really, they're 20 minutes away from going up 3-2 in this series, and it's all because of Dave Cameron's style and that using the four lines and all four lines being quite effective.
When you talk about the four lines, though, take a look at the fact there's almost a fifth line that's been going in and out of the lineup every game. Such is back in now for a couple games. Wise has come out of nowhere. Here's the guy that was brought in from Mississauga. No one knew anything about him except that he was Graham Wise's son, who's a great CIS coach. He's come out here and he's winning the hearts of people on that fourth line, making all kinds of crash and banging kind of plays.
Yeah, Derek Schoenmaker's not getting the start in this hockey game. Mika Partanen back in the lineup, and that's been a pretty strong line as well, the Maxim Kitson line with Jordan Mayer centering that one. All right, let's talk a little bit about the Owen Sound power play because that's the most pressing thing that the Majors have to look forward to in this third period because they're going to start the first 2 minutes of the third period shorthanded with Casey Cizikas, the captain, in the box. That's a double whammy because Casey Cizikas, probably their best penalty killer as well, best faceoff man, he's in the box. A huge 2 minutes to start the third period for the Majors.
Yeah, absolutely. But then you also have guys like Justin Chug doing the work shorthanded as well. You have, as Peter mentioned, Jamie Wise stepping up. He's been doing quite well on the penalty kill as well. And of course, Joseph Cramarosa, he's been in this role all year long, and I'm sure he'll step it up in the third period. Actually, in the second period, Dave Cameron was giving him, I guess, a piece of his mind for a couple plays happening in that second frame. But I mean, this Mississauga team is so deep, and the Owen Sound attack, well, they didn't really know, like, they knew what they wanted to do, during those first two power play opportunities throughout the first and second periods. They're looking very unorganized, and no one really wanted the puck, and it's going to be interesting to see how they come out in the third period, if they're going to come out a little bit more organized, communicate a little bit more, and obviously be a little bit more aggressive as well.
And when you take a look at it, it's all about the fact that Owen Sound has Petgrave on the point right there. Wilson and Hishon have been struggling. They've missed out on Fridge. But watch for the Owen Sound defensemen to get a little bit more active to help this Owen Sound power play get exciting. And they're not very good when they're static. They're good when they're coming through the no-two zone.
The Owen Sound attack in this hockey game, 0-2 on the power play. Haven't really been able to get much established with the extra man so far. It's early in this hockey game, just two opportunities. The Majors, on the other hand, a couple of power play goals already in this hockey game, both coming in the first period. So the Majors right now at least winning the special teams battle, and that has been the difference, obviously, when you look at the scoreboard and a 4-2 lead for the Mississauga St. Michael's Majors. We talk about pressure coming into this game, and I think if you ask most people, they would say the pressure was back on the Mississauga St. Michael's Majors after winning the first two games, and then all of a sudden they're back tied up at two games apiece with the Owen Sound attack. Maybe they alleviated some of that pressure going up 4-0 in the first period, and then two straight goals to end that first period. Maybe the pressure back on the Majors. Good second period, though. But this opening 2 minutes of this third period could really go a long way to settling the Majors down for the final 20 minutes of this hockey game, picking up a win.
Yeah, absolutely. They just need to do what they've been doing pretty much all night long and all season long, all playoffs long, and that's basically just getting in lanes. Mississauga St. Michael's Majors are fantastic at breaking up passes and getting in front of shots, blocking those shots. Owen Sound's just taking too much time with the puck, and then once they get their shot off, it's going off a defender, going off a stick, somewhere going off out of play, and they're not really getting a lot of shots in the direction of J.P. Anderson as much as they would like to anyways.
And when you talk about it, it's going to be great to see Mississauga play with some urgency. All year long, we've seen a team that's going to win a game 3-2, 4-3. Here's a team with a two-goal lead going into the third period. I'd like to see them just get a little bit more in a panic mode, treat it like it's a tie game, and put Owen Sound away in the third period.
Huge moment coming up to start the third period between the Mississauga St. Michael's Majors and Owen Sound attack. But first, let's send it upstairs to Brad and Will.
Thank you, Ben. Yeah, around the Canadian Hockey League right now. Of course, we have one game in the WHL opening up at 9 o'clock Eastern. They drop the puck. Portland and Kootenay, that series tied one game apiece the ice, earning the split at the Rose Garden down in Portland, Oregon. So they play game three in Cranbrook, BC at 9 o'clock. We'll watch on that one. QMJHL, quick update. St. John, 2-1 in that series against Gatineau. They play game number four tomorrow night. Game three was last night, St. John winning 5-0. Now, we've talked about the draft. We previewed it Friday. We've looked back on some of the big names that were drafted. One other one, Will Farquharson, who I want to talk about, is Subban, the third to go to the same exact OHL team.
Yeah, much like we had four Stahl brothers to play in the OHL, we've had a third Subban brother entering the OHL, and all three of them are going to be ending up playing for the Belleville Bulls. Jordan Subban is the youngest. He's a defenseman, much like his oldest brother, PK. And a lot of people are saying he has just as much potential, if not more, to be a really, really good offensive defenseman. So we'll see him enter the league and play alongside his brother Malcolm, who's a goaltender for the Bulls. And we did see him in the first round of this playoffs
against
Mississauga.
And he performed really well.
Yeah.
So that's the Subban situation. As far as what the Majors did in the draft, they had two picks in the first round. And what stuck out to me is very interesting is that in the first round, they used a pick on a goaltender.
Yeah, Mississauga's first pick came 18th overall, and they took goaltender Spencer Martin from the Junior Canadians. And obviously when you take a goaltender that early in a draft, you're looking to replace a need, and obviously they're looking ahead. Not that they need a goaltender right now immediately, but JP Anderson, you know, he won't be with this team forever, so they're looking ahead to replace him down the road. And Mississauga also had a second pick in the first round, 21st overall. They took Scott Teske, who also played for the Junior Canadian. So two teammates at the minor midget level now become two teammates at the OHL level.
We're fair and balanced. What did Owen Sound do in round one?
Owen Sound's first pick came 20th overall, and they took a forward from the Barrie Colts minor midget team, and his name is Zach Nastic, and he brings some more depth to their forward line. So that's how the attack fared in the first round.
So as we await that WHL game to get underway, we'll have a full update later on. In the meantime, updating you as best we can on what happened in that OHL draft, courtesy of the brain of Will Farquharson. Back to you, Ben.
That is a big brain on Will Farquharson as well. Good for him. Getting set here for the third period, the Mississauga St. Michael's Majors 20 minutes away from putting the Owen Sound attack on the brink of elimination and a 3-2 series lead. As mentioned, I think now the fifth time I've mentioned it, huge 2 minutes to start the third period for both teams. I guess mostly the Owen Sound attack because they do trail by two goals, but they're going to start the third period on a 2-minute power play. And this game, sort of in the tail of two periods, because the first one wide open, lots of goals, six goals in that first period, four straight by the Majors to start it, two straight by the Owen Sound attack. Second period, no goals, not a lot of chances either for either team. The Owen Sound attack maybe with the best chance with the puck off the post in the dying seconds. So what do we expect in the third period? Maybe a mix of both? Seems like it's a feast or famine for these two teams.
Yeah, absolutely. The momentum has just been swaying back and forth. Majors, Owen Sound. Majors were a majority of that period. Owen Sound, like you said, at the end of the period, getting the best of the chances. So maybe Owen Sound will start off with an early goal, make it 4-3, and then they'll play that desperation-type hockey, the Majors, that you were hoping for, Peter.
Well, I've noticed Stager's made some great glove saves, but he hasn't had any traffic in front of him. If Mississauga wants to pile it on here and take a bigger lead, they're going to have to put someone in front of the net.
Yeah, certainly a power play would help for the Mississauga St. Michael's Majors as well, because they've been great with a man advantage. Getting back to the first couple of games, how good they've looked with the extra man and Devontae Smith-Pelly playing high in the slot and playing a little bit of an umbrella style on the power play for the Mississauga St. Michael's Majors. But first, they got to get to the penalty kill, where they have been great as well during the playoffs. Maybe not as much during this series, because the Owen Sound attack have a great power play, but the Majors in general, over the playoffs, special teams much better than the regular season. Penalty kill, best in the league in the playoffs so far, and they're going to have to lean on that a little bit here to start the third period.
Yeah, absolutely. 16 of the 35 goals scored in this series have been with the man advantage. So
That's a lot,
exactly. We'll see if there's a 17.
I'm no math whiz, but I think that's 95%. Is that right? No, that's not right. Okay. All right, so we know that this series, this every game, every period has been completely unpredictable, but one thing is for certain, it doesn't seem like either team is content to just go into the Memorial Cup as whatever. I mean, this is very important to both teams to win the OHL championship and win, right, this Robertson Cup. Both teams very intent on winning this series.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, who wants to go as the first place losers?
Not me.
No.
And it was amazing. We were laughing about all the cliches they had. They actually meant it. They wanted to win this series, and they're not worried about saving anything for the Memorial Cup.
Absolutely not, and it is coming up May 20th in this building. The Mississauga St. Michael's Majors will play the winner of the QMJHL. Despite what happens in this series, the Mississauga St. Michael's Majors are going to open up the Memorial Cup against the Q. Of course, you can get tickets for the Memorial Cup. Just head to MississaugaStMichaelsMajors.com. As the third period coming up next, the Majors 20 minutes away from taking a 3-2 series lead.
Attack. Majors. Heading into the third period, the Majors have taken the lead and look to hold on and retake the series lead.
The chance scores! They're starting to pour it on now.
The ever-resilient Attack look to keep their heads up and exit the Hershey Center with their first series lead.
He's got a breakaway score!
The gutsy, determined effort on the road.
The third period begins.
Hi, I'm Bobby Gillespie, president of the Owen Sound Rotary Club. I'm here to thank our Owen Sound Attack Challenge sponsors, Their contributions make Rotary projects a reality.
Something to share? Let everyone know about your next meeting, your need for volunteers, or your fundraising event on the Rogers TV Community Billboard. Send us your words and we'll bring them to life on Rogers TV and RogersTV.com. When it's time to spread the word, go to RogersTV.com to add your announcement to the Community Billboard.
Now you can enjoy the Amazon Prime Video app on Ignite TV. Just say Amazon Prime Video into your Ignite voice remote and watch Amazon originals like The Expanse.
They want her to fight. We'll give her one.
The Wilds.
Are we in the actual Bermuda Triangle?
And The Boys.
That is amazing.
Prime members can stream Amazon originals, movies, TV shows, and more on Ignite TV today. Now you're in command.
There's the penalty box of the Mississauga St. Michael's Majors, and Casey Cizikas is sitting in there. He took a slashing penalty with no time left in the second period. That is not a good time to take a penalty, because the third period for Mark Reeds and the Owen Sound attack will begin on a power play. They trail 4-2, but a glorious chance here as we start period three of game five of the Rogers Ontario Hockey League Championship Series. I'm Roger Lajoie, Matt Scooby in the booth. Glorious opportunity for the boys in white here, man.
Very, another glorious one to start this period. And interesting, it'll be interesting to see, because this one's 4-on-3. Changes the dynamic a little bit about how you work your power play and how you're going to work it around. It'll be interesting to see what kind of strategy the attack come out with.
Good strategy by D'Souza there. He just fired that puck in Owen Sound territory instead of winning the faceoff. Just fired it back. Mark Kenton is back on the ice. He left late in that period with an apparent injury, but he's obviously all right. He's on this 4-on-3 penalty kill. Wilson with the puck. Puts it back for Hischen. Side for Blacker. Hischen again. Hischen for Wilson. Wilson for Hischen. They're in deep. Wilson face-off circle. Wines fires wide. Rebound behind the net. Canton watches it against the mesh. Wanted it to stay there. Referee says play it, and they do play it. That could turn out to be key. Canton had a chance to try to clear it, but let it sit on the mesh. Hischen takes it in a step. Blocked by D'Souza, and he can't control it, though. Boy, great block by D'Souza, but couldn't move it out. Here's Hischen again, and blocked again by D'Souza. Oh, that's paying the price, boy.
As big Fleming for D'Souza.
Thought about chasing it in and then stopped and went back. 58 seconds in the power play. Oh, this is huge. Hischen now at center, over the blue line. Takes a step, stops, looks. Hischen in the corner. Still 4-on-3 power play. Wilson and Hischen exchange passes. Blacker in front, McNarty scores! And the attack are back within one as Cizikas' penalty is costly.
Proves to be very costly indeed, Raj. In just a week when it looks like McNarty will extend his lead again, goal lead in the OHL playoffs. If he gets credit, it's his 15th of the season. He just throws it on net and it squeaks through. That's got to be tipped. A better angle from it up here. Great shot, yeah. Great tip in front by McNarty. And that's where the odd man is out in that 4-on-3 power play. Standing right in front of the net. There's nobody there to cover you. McNarty able to get a stick on it. Again, his 15th goal of this playoffs. Been absolutely outstanding for the attack.
The Majors' MO is supposed to be to take a two-goal lead, and Sia lights out. They had a four-goal lead. It's down to one. Cizikas doesn't see that pass. Kept in now, and here come the attack again. Pass in front, Gilbert. Can't center it, and taken away by the Majors.
Kramaros's pass is past the stick, and there's an icing call. We said before this game we have a new series. We have a new hockey game right now. It is 4-3 Mississauga, and lots of time left.
The dynamic has just completely changed here, and that's a big goal. That's exactly what Mark Reeds and this Owen Sound team needed in the first 2 minutes. There's only 3 seconds left. There's 4-on-4 hockey here, but you have to get a goal on a power play like that. And just a one-goal deficit. Exciting stuff, really.
It's great. Hey, listen, that's how you want it. It's excruciating when you're cheering for a team, but it's great hockey as Fleming's shot goes off a stick. And full credit to Owen Sound for getting back in this series and back in this game. Brace now has it in the corner. Pushed off the puck. Here comes Owen Sound again. Shaw's at center. Over the blue line. Shaw's shot goes wide. Percy knocks Shaw down. Percy, oh boy, this could turn out to be costly. Shot is just wide by Petgrave. The Majors fail to clear the zone. And the attack supporters in the crowd, and there's lots of them, are making the chant noise now. Shaw over the blue line. Shaw brings it in. Shot stopped by Percy. Percy chases it in deep. D'Souza couldn't control. Bernadov behind the net. Looks for room. Canton pushes at him. Canton controls, and there's the strength of a guy who's a veteran in this league right there, is Mark Canton. Won't be denied on that puck. He'll take his time now, set it up, let the line changes go. And Zizekas for Mississauga. Back pass for Canton. Smith Pelly off his skate, cleared right back in, and Gilbert will play it. Gilbert up for Maidens. Little back pass for Helas. Helas in over the blue line for Maidens. Maidens forced into the corner. Helas now along the board, still with it. Puts it back for Gilbert. Gilbert's shot, that's just wide. Comes out the back door. Smith Pelly will clear it to center off of Shug's stick. Gilbert back at center. Little back pass in, too far for Helas. DeMello's backhand, that's stopped. Here's Brace now with a step in. Brace shoots, and Anderson stopped that, but it went off the back of his goal stick and went in behind the goal. As Canton will play it deep for DeMello. DeMello, he almost lost it, but managed to get it out to center, and Gilbert fires it right back in. Jordan Mayer. Kitson makes a nifty move for Mayer. Mayer in deep, forced behind the goal, still with it. Jordan Mayer twisting and turning, still in the corner for Kitson. Behind the net, Kitson tries to bring it in front, no room there. Gilbert took it from him. And it's played up along the boards. Bodies collide, and it's cleared back into Mississauga zone where Percy will play it. Percy up for Mayer. Mayer over the blue line. Ahead a little too far for Kitson. Played back in the corner. Mayer, he gave it away. There's McNardy. Pass up for Hishon. Hishon over the blue line. Hishon streaking in, goes wide. Fleming takes him down. Percy battles for it, and Mayer comes away to Kitson. Maxim Kitson at center. Time for a line change, so he'll fire it in off the glass, and that allows the Majors to get some fresh bodies out there. Pass up the right side. Here's Hishon, brings it in. His shot blocked. Another shot there by McNardy. No, it's a passing shot. Anderson got turned around and wound up behind the goal as Brace shovels it to the corner. D'Orazio now for the Majors. Flicks it ahead for Flick. Flick gets around his man, has D'Souza in, Brace in deep. Here's Flick going in. His shot is high and wide. Corrente will keep it in. Takes a step of the blue line. His shot is blocked. Brace tried to center it in front. That hit a stick in front. Behind is D'Souza. D'Souza puts it back to the point for D'Orazio. D'Orazio, he'll move it in. Too far for Brace. Goes off the back of the net. Chipped up. Shaw is there. D'Souza, he'll take it from him, though. Puts it back for Corrente. Back far point, D'Orazio, his shot. And Scott Stager, who has been very steady since giving up those two goals after he came in, makes the save.
Better hockey from both these clubs. I think just a little bit more wide open. A couple of defensive turnovers, though, but again, both teams kind of opening, have to open it up just a little bit. You know the Majors don't want to, but they're being forced to just a little bit. And exciting as it is, you know that that guy, Dave Cameron, on the Majors bench, not going to be too pleased about how, you know, being able to cover the defensive zone, but also, you know, get a couple more shots on goal at this point. But again, 5 minutes, just over 5 minutes into this third period, one goal hockey game. Fans at home, you say, exciting stuff. Fans at home and the fans here at the Hershey Center can't ask for much more.
No, you sure can't, can you? Majors wrap around in front. Quick shot just wide by Wise. Oh boy, Jamie Wise wrapped that around. That didn't miss by much. In the corner, look at this battle. Now all these one-on-one battles, two-on-two in that case. Wise wins it, takes it behind the goal, still with it, but Shaw got it from him, then Wise squirts it, and that just went off the pad of Stager. Wise battling in the corner. Such now with some room, tried to bring it in front, but Shaw knocked it off the boards. Tenacious forechecking in deep by the Majors. Vernadov, though, manages to move it up to Petgrave, and Petgrave brings it up. Up the right side, left side, it's Shaw. Right side, rather. Shaw clears it in. DeMello. He avoids Petgrave, who's sliding in, and the Majors will clear it. Mark Canton. Ahead now for Smith-Pelly. He can't control, but Smith-Pelly will pick it up at the blue line anyway. Puts it back for Cizikas. He tries to worm his way in. No room. Gilbert plays it off the boards all the way into Mississauga zone. And Percy is back after it. Percy in his own end. Stops. Moves it up. Every clear so important now. That's off of Maidens and into the Majors bench. And Dave Cameron has to even duck past that one. 6:42 gone in the third period. The Owen Sound attack power play has put them right back in this game.
Yeah, David, not just the players on the ice dodging pucks, as Dave Cameron on the Mississauga bench. And speaking of dodging pucks, you know, you talk about Chris D'Souza, who had a couple of big blocks on the penalty kill. Yes, the Owen attack scored, but D'Souza in those blocking shots also on Sunday, game four on Sunday, a couple of big block shots as well.
Parton in at center for Mississauga. Fanned on it twice, but manages to clear it in finally. Goes in deep, and Cutting is after it. Cutting for Owen Sound. That's stopped by Kitson. Long pass. D'Orazio gives it right to Helis, but Brace could not get outside the blue line, so that'll be an offside. Boy, this stuff is great, isn't it? We call it the Rogers Ontario Hockey League Championship Series, and game six, Thursday night, back in Owen Sound with those great fans at the Harry Lumley Bayshore Community Center. We'll have that game and all games in the OHL final. As many more as that will be here on Rogers TV. Mayer now brings it in for Mississauga. Mayer forced wide by Maidens. Mayer is in the corner. Centers in front. Wise's shot. Stager got a piece of that. There's Mayer. Gets it again. Tries to avoid Maidens. Falls. Gets back up. Wise comes in to help him out. Maidens, though, will play it smartly to Cutting. And he'll manage. No, he doesn't clear it. Kitson took it from him. Here's Kitson with a shot. That's off a stick wide. Maidens goes after it. Kitson runs into his man. Doesn't have a, somebody's lost a stick. It was Cutting, but he picks it up and gets it back. D'Orazio ahead for Wise. Wise shoots it in. Majors making those changes. So important now, this stage of the game, this stage of the series, this stage of the season. Get the fresh bodies out. Cizikas almost took it from Cutting, but Cutting was able to control. On the forecheck, the Majors try to keep it in. Fleming will shoot it in. Cizikas has to go out. Laid offside is waved. And Gilbert plays it behind the Owen Sound goal. Kept in by Shug. Shug takes a step, pass in, Cizikas fans on it, then raffled it through right into Stager. And Casey Cizikas looks up to the heavens. Boy, would he love a goal to make up for that penalty he took, but Scott Stager stopped him, and Cizikas just couldn't get anything on it.
And just puck just squirted off his stick as well. And get a look at Stager. Look who is in the building as well. It's Cliff Fletcher, former general manager of the Toronto Maple Leafs, taking in the action here in Mississauga.
Commissioner Dave Branch stopping by to say hello as well. Commissioner of the OHL, president of the CHL. And Silver Fox Cliff Fletcher, distinguished hockey man, isn't he? Hockey Hall of Famer. Sure, everyone enjoying the game tonight. Hope you are too. Fleming fires it. That trickles just wide. Shug with the rebound, takes it into the corner. Shug. Forced in deep, still battling along the boards. Back for Percy, but Percy can't keep it in. Last man back, got to be careful, and Fleming joins him back in his own zone. Fleming ahead into Owen Sound territory. Stager will leave it, and the attack bring it up off the boards. D'Souza, he'll backhand it in. Stannis back in his own zone. Brace will keep it in. Brace now as the Majors try to get some forechecking pressure in. D'Souza after his man, but Bernadov clears it out. Here comes the attack. Shaw goes in after it. Shaw's backhand, but DeMello was there to take it, and that's a good clear by the Majors as D'Souza follows it to center. Petgrave avoids a check, tries to move it in. Flick ahead to D'Souza. D'Souza still with it now. Pass in for Brace, off his skate. Flick tried to move it in. He's pushed to the ice. Gilbert and D'Souza collide. D'Souza goes down in a heap behind the Owen Sound net. Halmo now for Shaw the other way. Shaw brings it in. Fires. Big save. Big rebound. Where is it? Majors clear it to the corner. Bernadov along the boards. Tried to pick it up, and D'Souza will take it away for the Majors and just trickle it into Owen Sound territory. That is going to be icing, however. And with 9:53 to go in the third period, 4-3 Mississauga. Cliff Fletcher's in the house, and Alicia Warner is with Cliff.
Just going to do a pass here.
Hello, everybody. Here with Special Advisor to the Toronto Maple Leafs, Cliff Fletcher, enjoying some OHL hockey here. I'm sure one name coming to mind is Jesse Blacker that you have your eye on tonight.
Well, we like his potential. We think he's a tremendously talented young player, and we're looking forward to him becoming a professional next year.
Are there any other players, particularly maybe you won't name names, but that you're here to see tonight, or maybe just the tempo of play, the style of play?
Well, I just wanted to come and see the top two teams in the OHL, and I'm looking forward to coming back here during the Memorial Cup in a couple of weeks' time. And it's an interesting game tonight. Mississauga, when they had the 4-0 lead, I thought the game was over, but Owen Sound is definitely showing some resiliency.
Certainly a fight all the way to the Memorial Cup. Cliff Fletcher, guys, back to you.
Alicia, thank you. Cliff Fletcher looking well, and boy, he nailed this game. A lot of people thought the game might have been over when it was 4-0 Mississauga, and maybe some guys wearing blue jerseys might have thought it was over, but it is not by any stretch. Owen Sound with the draw, half a period still to play. In regulation, that is, as Cramarosa puts it in the corner for Canton. Back pass for Kitson. He'll chip it out. Wise with a nice play to control it. Wise has Cramarosa with him, ahead to Cramarosa, and that's just off his stick. Wise in the corner. Battles deep. Cramarosa fires. That's wide. DeMello will keep it in for Mississauga. This checking line for the Majors. Majors have all checking lines, but this one in particular, you think at some point would be rewarded for its work with a goal. As Wise takes it. Back pass at the point. DeMello put in for Kitson in the corner. He just fired it through and winds up on a giveaway, really. That's not what Kitson wanted to do there, as DeMello shoots it right back into Owen Sound territory. Stager will leave it. Here come the attack. Long pass at center, tipped into the stands. That's a whistle, of course, and we will have a face-off. 8:59 to play at the blue line.
Minus the power play goal at the start of the period. I think this first line of the Owen Sound attack is being outplayed as we take a look at the last chance. Wise's pass, great little backhand saucer pass, and just over the stick of Cramarosa. But I think as the first lines are back out there again, these two lines have been matched up all game long, and the Majors' first line has dominated so far, in my opinion, to this point in this hockey game.
Cleared up at the blue line. Cizikas tries to push Brace. These one-on-one battles or something. There's Blacker. Cliff Fletcher and all of us watch him flip it in. Goes in behind the net. Look at Blacker go after it. Pushed off the puck. Shug will try to move it. He can't. Hishin will keep it alive. Back to the point. Shot by Brace. High off the glass. All the way back to Stannis. He whacks at it. Trickles in. There's Hishin again. Or rather, Blacker. He turns. Back for Stannis. Shot is blocked. Chance for a break here. Shug's got it. Shug with a break. Shug ahead of Stannis. Goes in. Backhand. Scores! Justin Shug again! How big is that goal? 5-3 Mississauga.
A huge play from Justin Shug, a great move, but this play starts back at the Mississauga blue line. Blacker with a good pass and just trying to be too offensive. It was a bad pass to begin with, but he can't make the play like that. I'm pretty sure it stands. And then Shug comes to the backhand, sneaks it through Fifel, and you said it, Raj, that is a huge goal for this Majors team with only 8 minutes and 14 seconds left in this third period. Stannis, again, got caught, can't force that shot at the Mississauga blue line. Leads to Shug's second goal of this game, and he continues to be huge. Four game-winning goals so far in the playoffs.
Another big one.
Watch this attack team, though. You know they're going to come fighting back. That's all they do is battle back. Down 2-0 in the series. Down 4-0 tonight. Until they got back to within one with Shug with that big goal. And that's kind of a dose of their own medicine. Shug with a breakaway pass and quick breakout pass. Picking it up and firing it in. And Shug with the big goal. Cutting, picks it up for Shaw at center. Shaw brings it in over the blue line. Shaw, pass in deep. Almo took it deep, in behind the goal now. Pushed into the corner. And Kitson will pick it up. All right, the Majors had the 4-0 lead. Gave that up. Had the 2-0 series lead. Gave that up. Now with a 2-goal lead and 7 minutes and 10 seconds left in the third period. Don't have to say any more than that. They do not want to give this up again. The attack have battled and battled in this series. Battled tonight. Look to be down and out early. Now need a couple of goals and in relatively short order, although 6:50 is a lifetime left on the clock in the OHL, isn't it? And McNardy was knocked down and hurt. He goes off, bent over to the bench. Keep an eye on him. Brought in, Helis behind the net. Maidens tries to pick it up. Grace will pick it up, can't clear it, and finally Flick will take it at center. Pass for D'Souza, and D'Souza will shoot it in, and the Majors now are going to shorten the bench. It's a number one line again, Tsitsikas, Smith-Pelly, and Shug. But you know you need fresh bodies out there as Petgrave brings it in. Petgrave slides it in. Fleming plays it off the boards. The Major strength, team depth, rolling the lines. See if they can take advantage of that now. Owen Sound strength, gritty efforts, never quit, and they've just taken a penalty as Percy was knocked down in front. I was going to say the attack, gritty efforts, some talented forwards of their own, but boy, that is a poor time to take a penalty.
Helis with just an undisciplined penalty right in front of the official again, in front of the Majors net. Undisciplined. 5 minutes, 6 minutes left in this game. You can't be taking a penalty like that when you're down 2 goals. But let's have another look at that goal. As you'll see the pass that came across for Stannis. There's a shot standing right in front of him with Shug. You can't take a shot like that, but then Shug all the way through. Great body position, goes to his backhand. Another real smart play. Shug trying to become only the second player to win 3 straight Memorial Cups. Robert Savard. The last one, going back to the early 80s.
Pass is, I don't know what the call there. They had a whistle. Offside. Canton doesn't agree, but linesman said he took it outside the blue line, so they'll do the face-off. Well, before the Memorial Cup is the Rogers OHL Championship Series to win, and that's the battle now for the Majors, but Owen Sound, first task for them, kill this penalty. And don't count on them not scoring shorthanded. How many times have we seen that quick breakaway pass in this series?
Robbie McNardy stayed on the bench as Owen Sound for a while, so hopefully he's okay.
We'll keep an eye on him. Didn't go to the dressing room. That's a good sign as Canton plays it into Smith-Pelly. Smith-Pelly for Shug. Shug back for Canton. Shug takes a step. Winds, no, in deep. Smith-Pelly centered right through the crease. Percy goes out the back door. Little back pass for Tsitsikas. Tsitsikas for Percy. Percy for Canton. Canton in deep. There's Shug. Side of the net. Shug in front. Caught up. Percy! Oh, how did that stay out? Off the post. Twice scored! Doesn't stay out this time. Smith-Pelly might have just sealed the deal.
That first one, Raj, went off the post and came to the side of the net. And all 4 Owen Sound players on the ice just stood around and watched as Smith-Pelly jumped on the rebound. There's the first one that hits the post, and then they all just kind of watch. And watch the puck, and watch Smith-Pelly put the puck in the back of the net. His second of the hockey game, and that, barring anything crazy, and with what we've seen in this series so far, it's maybe not impossible to think we could see a comeback, but that one will likely do it.
Well, it's a big goal, 5:11 to play. That's still a lot of time. But it is a 3-goal lead, and that's a lot of goals to come back from. As Shug and Smith-Pelly, and you talked, man, all night about this number one line, how good they've been. Now they've both got 2 goals here tonight. and some breathing room for now. We'll never sell this Owen Sound team short. Here's Childerly the other way. Fires it in. Goes off the back of the net. Sweep goes after it. He's pushed off the puck. Kitson tried to move it ahead. Chipped off the boards. Mayer just shovels it into Owen Sound territory. And that's an icing call. 4:39 to play in regulation. The Majors have a 6-3 lead.
Cipelli's 13th goal of the playoffs. And again, Roger, you mentioned that number one line. They've been absolutely outstanding tonight. They've outplayed the number one line of the attack. Dave Cameron has to be happy with it, with his team's effort again, and responding in the third period again. Coming down, they go down a goal early in the period, but they've come back with two more to take a three-goal lead. So give them some credit at this point.
Let's see if the attack have yet another rally in them tonight. Kitson brings it in for the Majors. For Partnan. Partnan shoots it in along the boards. Kitson plays it in deep. Mayer is there. Mayer in the corner. Looks for a little room. Mayer still battling for Kitson. Kitson behind the net. Tries to push his man off the puck. Kitson back for Canton. Canton, far point, DeMello. DeMello shot, deflected wide. Mayer, another penalty coming, no one sound, and they'll touch it. And with 3:50 left, that's pretty well going to seal it, because we got a high sticking penalty coming to Owen Sound, and Kitson does the wise thing, skates off, although now we get a little more extracurricular activity here. Zweep trying to stir things up, and if you're the attack, you may as well try to take somebody with you here for sure. Sweep is just going to be sent by the linesman to the Owen Sound bench, and his night is over.
Kitson still having words down below us with Gilbert as well. But again, this is going to, you know, this last 4 minutes of this hockey game again, as cliche as it will be, it'll be about setting the tone again for next game back in Owen Sound. Smith has gone to the box for Owen Sound. DeMello goes for Mississauga. Sweep is still standing in the hallway as well.
Yeah, Sweep was just sent by the linesman to the Owen Sound bench and is standing there, so I just assumed maybe he'd gotten a misconduct penalty, but he is still standing there. He's going to wait for the call, as will we, as the referees will do that at the penalty timekeeper's bench. 6-3, the Majors lead. Mark Reeds looks at the scoreboard. Sure doesn't like what he sees. 3:50 to play, and knowing what a smart coach he is, he's already thinking, all right, what do we got to do now Thursday night? As Jesse Blacker has a conversation with Scott Stager.
You mentioned a couple of times Jamie Weiss tonight, Rog, and it really speaks to, he knows his role with this team and knows now at this point, after he was, you know, involved in the middle of this with Sweep. Sweep tried to drop a glove and Weiss was just talking to him, but he didn't take a stupid penalty. He didn't punch back, or he didn't take anything, any extra action beyond what it was. The only penalty up on the board right now is to Dylan DeMello. But again, give Weiss some credit at this point, to, you know, for keeping his cool at center ice, and that's what it has to be about for the Majors now. No stupid penalties at the rest of this period. You know that the attack are going to come out and be jawing and trying to get all the extracurriculars going, but don't get caught up in any of that.
I don't know if they got the right number up or not, but it's a Majors power play. The extra minor has gone to Owen Sound, so it's going to be 5-on-4 here for the Majors. 3:50 to play in the third period. They're up 6-3. And on the power play again, here's Canton for Shug. Shug fakes a shot, takes a step, deflected, scores! Smith Pelly's got the hat trick. 7-3, Mississauga.
This one from Justin Shug as well, so chalk up another couple of points for the first line of the Majors. Not too much celebration now. They know it's not the time for that. But Smith Pelly, what a game he's had. On the score sheet three times, but also as well, just working real hard down low for this Majors Cup. As you get, take another look. Shug, middle of the ice, Smith Pelly, where he's lived for this series, in the middle of that slot, to the top of that slot, feeding the puck. We had him, you know, he could have had another one earlier in this game as well. Same kind of exact same play, just a feed to him, get the tip on it, get the stick on the puck. 4-goal lead now for the Majors.
That says a lot about the Majors there, folks. 7-3. And there was no fivings, no fist to the bench, no nothing. Just, okay, this one looks to be safely in hand. Let's not get ridiculous. And even in the fifth game of the OHL final, that's the way they behave in game two of the regular season. It's the way they behave in game five of the OHL final. What you see is what you get with the majors. Every game is the same. And there's a lot to be said for that. Owen Sound now will try to answer this challenge and build for Thursday night, because you know, are they going to have a fantastic arena filled with fans there tomorrow night. Maybe get another goal here, create a little momentum, but Such will take it out. Dump it into Owen Sound territory. Blacker goes back behind his own goal for the attack. Blacker brings it up right side. D'Souza chipped it ahead. Gilbert brings it in over the blue line. Gilbert winds, fires, blocked by Canton. Played back, and there's D'Souza. D'Souza for the majors. In over the blue line. His shot kicked out by Stager. Scooped up by Owen Sound. No, taken away again by the majors. Flick tries to get past his man. Puts it in behind for Mayer. Mayer bumps with Gilbert. D'Souza is in there for Flick. Both battle and the puck underneath them. Have a whistle, and I think we might have had a late hit there by the majors. And we have a scrum in the corner with 2:11 to play.
D'Souza in the middle of it. A great shot right in the corner. And a couple of, there's another big punch, and made, I think D'Souza went down. Can't see what attack player it is. D'Souza just took one right in the chops, I think. It's going to be, I think, pretty sure that was Andrew Shaw that turned around and socked the majors forward.
Shaw did. His night is done. He is going off, and there is a lot of blood there on the ice as D'Souza is getting attended to.
There's some more pushing and shoving now in the slot area. Brett Fleming.
It looks to be in the chin area. Fleming now tries to answer. This is where, you know, you don't like to see any of this kind of stuff. Let's watch this punch.
There it is. The shot just came around.
The shot just came around the haymaker and cut him on the cheek. It looks to be the cheek. Hard to see our cheek or nose.
Maybe the bloody nose.
Bloody nose, and it smarts.
Linesman signaled right away, though, to the referee that he was going to take Shaw, that he was done. I don't think this is completely unexpected either to happen, but it's not fun to see, especially when a game is out of hand in a final series, when we haven't seen a lot of this to this point in this series.
No, this has been a fiercely competitive series. There's been a lot of hitting, a lot of shots that you're going to see, but for the most part, no, both teams have conducting themselves well. D'Souza has a word for the Owen Sound bench as he skates off. And now a second word as the attack answer back. Save it for Thursday, because that's when these two teams are going to hook up again. And that is game six of the Rogers Ontario Hockey League Championship Series. D'Souza will be attended to in the dressing room. Likely have to get some stitches as a result of that.
Going to be an interesting decision, Raj, sorry, for Mark Reeds. And who do you start in goal now? Right, Zador started for this one. Gave up two goals early. Stasier's come in. He's given up, five goals now to this point. But I think he's been the better goaltender. I think he was the better goaltender. But I get another goaltending dilemma brewing for Reeds.
I would agree. It's a decision. There's no question about it. Michael Zador was terrific in the two overtime. Oh, just terrific. He was terrific Sunday.
Sunday, yeah.
6-5 game. He was good. Good enough, obviously, when you win the game. And then they gave up two weak goals to start this game. The decision was made to pull him. But you're right, Matt. There is a decision for Mark Reeds to wrestle with. All right. Do I try Stager again or maybe Zador? I would suspect it'll be Stager, but we'll see.
I suspect it as well. Interesting to see, with Jordan Binnington in the mix as well. I don't think that he will even dress for that game again. Just being a rookie, he played really well for the attack earlier in the year. Struggled in the playoffs, though.
Bottom line, 3-minute power play for the majors. I don't think I've ever seen a 3-minute power play.
I was going to say, I think this was
my life.
Thought it was a mistake.
That's what it says. 3-minute power play. All right. Parente for D'Orazio. His shot goes wide, goes all the way back into majors territory. 7-3 Mississauga. Now all the majors, I think, want to do is get this one into the books and get ready for Thursday night. The attack in the same kind of mode here. Framarosa, left side at center, backhands it in. Petgrave is back. He'll fire it all the way into majors territory. And Anderson will leave it behind his net. Corrente will take his time. No urgency to this power play. Majors just want the clock to tick down. 53 wins in the regular season for Mississauga. This will be playoff win 15. That's 68. But guess what? That's not enough for an OHL title. They're going to need one more at 69. And you know that's not going to come easy. This was a strange one tonight. Went back and forth. Mississauga, four goals, all the momentum. Owen Sound, three goals and a lot of the momentum. Oh, but that breakaway goal by Justin Shug. That was the dagger tonight as the attack bring it up. Now Helas has a break. He comes down the right side, centered in front into the glove of Anderson. He'll smother it and hold on. But the Major's about to head back down to Owen Sound with the series lead as Petgrave knocks down Kramarosa. Now a glove in the face.
More rough stuff, and D'Orazio battling with Helas. They're going to let them go, apparently.
And D'Orazio is drilling Helas with a few punches. Now Helas gets a few in of his own. Pretty good heavyweight battle. Now D'Orazio answers back with about four punches. Now it's getting real nasty out there. And this put this one under unnecessary.
Yeah, I would go with the unnecessary at this point. Benches are going to thin out. But it was announced, I believe, that Andrew Shaw got a match penalty for reffing, or for roughing. Sorry, excuse me. So that could mean some further discipline. I believe that carries with it an automatic one-game suspension.
We'll have to check on that,
but I'll tell you what, sucker
punch to the chin in the fifth game of the OHL Finals, not the smartest thing you're ever going to do in your career.
No, absolutely
and
not.
Dave Cameron is yelling at somebody. I don't know if it's a referee or his own guys there. I think he'd just love to see this 52 seconds down. Man, how intense is that guy, eh? Take a look at him. Look at this guy.
Regardless of score, regardless of situation,
7-3,
going to be yelling.
52 seconds to play. You think, all right, well, we got the series lead back again, but still intense as the two captains listen in to the referee's explanation. And this is important, of course, just for future penalties and
in a situation like the Shaw one, the discipline right. That could come. It game six in a final that when your season is on the line.
Look at this. This is Dave Cameron having a discussion with his players. And Kramarosa was one of the majors who took the extra swing at the goal, and he's making it clear to him. See, look what happens.
What happens when we don't
learn to turn away here. I mean, where's the advantage for Mississauga here?
That was about as intense as it gets, and a great shot from the guys on the camera from the crew. Our great crew here at Rogers TV, but what a great shot there. Kramarosa getting an earful, to say the least.
Maxim Kitson skating off to the dressing room. We'll listen in.
To Owen Sound, number 37, Liam Helas, 5 for fighting.
Kitson gets a 10-minute misconduct. That's why he skated off, so no injury. He just was talking a little too much, perhaps, and he's left. Let's see if we can get through this last 40 seconds of regulation time here without any more trouble. Percy will shoot it in. Brace bumps his man, laid back. Such for Percy. Percy at the point, lost control, takes it back to center. And take it all the way back into his own zone. Now a little back pass for Such. Such ahead for Brace. Brace looks for Partanen. Partanen alone, centered in front. That's off a stick. Such picks it up in the corner. 13 seconds left in the corner for Brace. Brace takes a step, two steps, passes in front through the crease. Nobody there. Canton will take it back, and he's just going to skate around with it. He knows better. There's no point in rubbing this in because Mississauga has a 3-2 series lead. We can save the competitiveness for Thursday night.
It's a little bit of a chippy ending, but I think overall, Majors came out and played the third period they had to and really established at this point that they were the dominant team. The four-goal lead almost let it slip away with that early goal by the attack in the third period, but came back and added three more on a dominant, another couple of dominant power play goals as well.
Smith, Pelly, and Shug doing it. The big line, three for Smith, Pelly, two for Shug. Big point night for Cizikas. The Mississauga St. Michael's Majors are one win away from an Ontario Hockey League championship, where they're going to have to get that win in Owen Sound on Thursday night, or it's back here for Game 7 on Sunday afternoon. Let's check in with the thoughts of our panel.
Mississauga St. Michael's Majors now with 15 wins out of their goal of 16 here in the Ontario Hockey League playoffs. Welcome back upstairs to Hershey Center. I'm Ben Ennis, joined by Michelle Storino and Peter Curtis. The Mississauga St. Michael's Majors come away with the 7-3 win in Game 5 over the Owen Sound Attack, sort of hanging on midway through that game and then taking control in the third period. Interesting that we have the CHL president, David Branch, just standing off camera right here. He was intently watching the last couple of seconds of this game for potential suspensions or supplemental discipline. I don't know if we'll see any of that for Game 6 Thursday night in Owen Sound, but sort of a tough way to finish this game, which was a great game played by both teams.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, we talked about momentum. So Mississauga, Owen Sound. Owen Sound had some momentum by making it 4-3 at the beginning of the period. And like you mentioned in the second intermission, those 2 minutes, that power play was crucial, and it was. It got them within that one goal. But Mississauga, from then on out, it was all Justin Shug. And I guess an unfortunate way to end the game after such a high-paced game. But, I mean, everything's on the line here for Owen Sound, and this is setting a very, very good tone for Thursday night. I'm excited to see it.
Well, you have to wonder if part of that was the fact that the number one power play line came out with that big lead, and a few of the Owen Sound players, I'm sure, were saying, okay, you guys have won this game. What do you really need to prove? Kind of sets a tone for Game 6, like you say, Michelle. But we'll see. You know, they both want their prize there. They're going to come out and play disciplined hockey in Game 6.
I'm going to disagree with you a little bit about that. We talked about this when we were watching the game, that you weren't sure that was the correct move for Dave Cameron to have his number one power play unit out there with a three-goal lead. There were still 4 minutes to go, though, and we've seen big leads in this series evaporate. So I'm not completely convinced that that wasn't the right play by Dave Cameron. It's the Rogers OHL Championship Series. I don't think it was necessarily a bad move. Maybe Mark Reeds took it as a little bit of a slap in the face. I don't know if he should have, though.
Well, do you think that's the reason why Chris D'Souza ended up at the bottom of that scrum there in the corner?
Might have just been a frustration thing for both teams, but I don't know. What do you think? Actually, you know what, Peter? Just don't want to cut you off. That was kind of rude. I'm sorry. You get plenty of time to talk. We got to talk for half an hour, but Alicia Warner's got Chris D'Souza downstairs.
Oh, here with second star of the game, Justin Shug. He's here asking some of his own questions, but we're going to turn the table and ask him, how good did that win feel after back-to-back OT losses?
Yeah, I mean, it's just two bounces away from winning those games, and I mean, it's obviously tough to lose two overtime games back-to-back, but the guys responded well here.
Talk about the emotion, especially in that third period when fists started flying, whistles started blowing, and blood was going on the ice. What was going on in your guys' heads?
Yeah, the third period was great. I mean, we gave up a 4-0 lead to a 4-2, but the boys really sprung back quite well, and we were taking the body and being physical, and it really showed.
If anybody knows resiliency, it's either you or Mark Canton, knowing how momentum so easily shifts in a series like this. Is it hard to kind of put to the side the fact that you could win yet another Ontario Hockey League championship in Owen Sound next game?
Yeah, I mean, I don't want to think about it too much. I mean, still could be two games left to play, but it's definitely exciting thinking that we're just one game away.
Just one game away is a possibility for Justin Shug and the Mississauga St. Michael's Majors, who earned a 7-3 victory here at the Hershey Center tonight. We'll send it back upstairs.
That snap,
for him, a couple of goals. Devontae Smith-Pelly, the number one star, obviously, he had the hat trick, and we will hear from him as well. Don't be concerned. We'll hear from Devontae Smith-Pelly. He was the number one star, and he will be a part of the post-game press conference, which we will have for both teams. Mark Reeds and Dave Cameron going to speak after this game as the Mississauga St. Michael's Majors come away with a big 7-3 win over the Attack. More post-game reaction coming up next on Rogers.
Hi, I'm Bobby Gillespie, president of the OnSound Rotary Club. I'm here to thank our OnSound Attack Challenge sponsors. Their contributions make Rotary projects a reality.
Looking for the best way to get the Major League Baseball games you want to watch? Rogers Super Sports Pack has you covered. With MLB Extra Innings, you'll have a premium ticket to out-of-market regular season games with all games available in HD. Don't miss the action from the games you want from both the American and National Leagues. MLB Extra Innings, part of the Super Sports Pack. For only $35.95 a month, Rogers customers get all this for one all-inclusive price. Order using your remote starting on channel 431 or visit rogers.com today.
On Rogers TV, we have a reality show like no other. It has a great cast of characters. Some you may have even helped land the role. Each episode has something different. Plans are devised, decisions are made, votes are cast, and money is spent. It's local reality TV that you won't want to miss. And it's exclusive to Rogers Cable customers. Catch your municipal council coverage on Rogers TV. Visit rogerstv.com for broadcast details.
Hi, I'm David Sherman, host of Politically Speaking. Join me for my next show, and my guests will be the Blue Water District Roman Catholic School Board on Politically Speaking on Rogers TV.
In the Rogers Ontario Hockey League Championship Series, Majors lead the series 3-2 with a chance to close it out Thursday night in Owen Sound. Roger Lajoie and Matt Scooby with you. We'll save you the obvious adjectives of big win because there are no little games left in the OHL season. But Matt, the Majors, this game like the series, 4-0 lead. Owen Sound comes back, make it 4-3. Majors win 7-3, like the series, 2-0 to 2-2. Who knows what happens Thursday?
Just kind of back and forth, I think, Raj. And again, it's like just like the series, we saw it, and it was just kind of both ways. The Majors would play well for the first half of a period, give up a couple of chances to the Attack, especially in the first period, then at the end of the second period with some pressure, Attack with an early goal in the third period, and then the Majors took it all back and took all the momentum back and really got it going and got three more goals to cap it all off. Back and forth, what we've seen, I think maybe more goals than we expected at this point, and a goaltending situation, as we talked about near the end of the broadcast, coming up, a big decision for Mark Reeds, who starts in game six for him. But again, you don't want to miss game six in Owen Sound. It's going to be a dandy.
Will be a dandy. Rogers TV will have it for you, of course. And you look again at the importance of this game for the Majors to reestablish momentum. But Matt, the way it's gone back and forth, the momentum swings every period, every half period here. So I don't think anybody has a real edge here. And let's end the discussion now. Please, nobody else anywhere, anytime say that these guys don't care about the OHL championship because they're playing for the Memorial Cup. Because anybody who says that does not understand the kids, the league, or what's at stake here. You tell me these teams don't want to win an OHL title.
It's crazy. And you think about the emotion, too. Go back to the last half of that third period as well. Maybe emotions boiled over just a little bit. But they're out there, and they're out there competing. And Mark Reed said it, too. I talked to him before the game. I'm sure he'll reiterate it after the game as well in his press conference, that these kids care, that these coaches care, that it's not just shoved aside because it's the Memorial Cup and they won a national championship. An OHL championship, Dave Cameron said it before as well, before the series started. An OHL championship is more important to him than the Memorial Cup because it's more of a just, it's a one game kind of tournament, and you know, it's anybody's, almost anybody's tournament at this point, depending on who's playing well or any number of other factors. These kids want to be here. These kids have played their hearts out, and it really has been a spectacular series like we've seen, back and forth, and I really don't think we can ask for too much more at this point from both of these teams. Number one teams in both conferences coming out of the regular season. It's been great so far, and really excited to watch the conclusion of what happens.
Full value to Owen Sound as well. Hey, they had 46 wins as well, only 7 fewer than the Majors. They've also picked up 14 playoff victories, 2 back-to-back overtime, gut-wrenching wins. I have no doubt they will answer Thursday night in Owen Sound. And if the Majors are going to win at Owen Sound, they'll have to bring their A game again and get out of that habit of these lapses that are hurting them, or Owen Sound can burn them, because the Owen Sound Attack have definitely showed they belong in this series. In fact, they are one of the premier teams, if not the premier team in this league.
Yeah, the Mississauga Majors have to avoid those. It's those late period lapses. And on the other side, Owen Sound has to avoid all these penalties that early that are just killing them. It's so hard to win a hockey game when you go down 4-0. You have a goaltender change. Reed did everything he could to try and get his team motivated. But a 4-goal lead, especially against a team like the Majors, give them a lot of credit for almost coming all the way back. But you can't do that against a team, especially, you know, I think it'll be different. I think there'll be a little bit more energy going back to Owen Sound, playing at home, playing in their building where they, honestly, while listening to that broadcast in Game 4, probably one of the loudest things, and I wasn't even there. I can only imagine how loud it is actually is there in person, but it's going to be absolutely insane. They need to draw energy from that crowd, not take any more stupid penalties, get a couple of early goals possibly, but they're right there, and they can't count themselves out yet and can't look forward yet. They are right there in this series as of right now.
Can't wait to be there Thursday night. It'll be a lot of fun. Just moments from now, we'll be going down to the post-game press conference and get the comments. The Attack have certainly done everything they can, but from the Majors' perspective, Matt, this was the year they've built for. This has been a work in progress for 3 years. Dave Cameron, 68 victories so far this year, but you can't get the Robertson Trophy unless they win one more. 69. The oldest cliche in hockey, perhaps, is a fourth game of a series is the toughest to win, and boy, oh boy, that's going to be the case here.
It is going to be the case, and you know, Owen Sound, again, full credit, like you said, full credit to them that they'll come and pressure. But Mississauga has to stick to their game plan, and you don't want to use the cliches. Again, Mark Reed's before the game. The cliches are used because there's some truth to them. It's not that we just want to keep using them over and over again.
No, we want to keep using them over and over again. Yeah. But that's
so it's just kind of like there is some truth to them, but at this point, the Majors have to play their game and just keep going, and you know, hopefully they'll come out on top in Game 6.
Let's get downstairs. Post-game press conference, Mark Reed and Joey Hishon.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the post-game press conference, the Rogers OHL Championship Series. Joined now with Owen Sound Attack head coach Mark Reeds and forward Joey Hishon. Coach, we'll start with you. Boys showed the ability to battle back in the second period, but didn't get the outcome you were hoping for. Talk about the game.
Obviously, I have to take responsibility for it. We weren't prepared to play in the first period. Some of the mistakes that our D made, we just weren't ready to play. And, to get down 4-0 and then expect to fight your way back, against a good hockey club, that's just not going to happen. And, I guess we made a game of it. You can call it what you want. Opportunity at the end, and we turn over the puck, and Shug goes down and buries a good opportunity, and then the game just kind of slips away. But, in the first period again, you can say undisciplined penalties, I don't know. I'll look at them again and I'll do my review. But again, you get behind the eight ball, every game, you're not going to win that way.
Joey, for you, the guys have shown the ability to beat this Majors team, and you've done it twice. And heading back to your building, there's got to be some confidence. Just what do you guys need to do heading back for Game 6?
St. Mike's plays very well through the middle of the rink, and they're very, very strong defensively, so we know that, but like you said, we've proven that we can beat them and play with them on a nightly basis, so I think we got to work hard. We've been doing that all series, but like I said, they play very well through the middle of the rink, and it's hard to create offense against a strong defensive team like that, but we've shown we can do it, and we're gonna do that back in Owen Sound.
We'll now take questions, but ask you if you do have a question to please wait for the microphone to reach you.
Coach, tonight the Cizikas line combined for 10 points in the game. What do you guys got to do to shut them down in Game 6 and try and force a Game 7 back here at the Hershey Center?
Well, we have to stay out of the penalty box, first of all. A lot of their points, but again, they're very strong as a line, and again, the depth of their team is showing. They're able to kind of wear down RD, and we try to get the matchup that we're looking for, and obviously, they're a heck of a line. They play very well for each other and with each other. And, tonight they showed again why, they're one of the top lines and leaders of their hockey club.
Mark, can you tell us who will start in goal in Game 6 if you've decided that yourself yet?
Well, that'd be a pretty interesting question there. I won't divulge that information right now.
Mark and Joey, you looked like you were on the verge of coming back. You started the third period very strong, got the score to 4-3, and then roughly, I thought about around the 9-10 minute mark, things seemed to get away from you. Then the Majors took control of the game from that point. What exactly went wrong at that point in your estimations?
Well, I think Shug scored a very timely goal for them. That was huge, and I mean, the game wasn't out of hand then, I don't think. I think we were still in it and still battling hard, but then we took a penalty right after that, and they capitalized on that opportunity. So after that, I think there was about 6 or 7 minutes left, and we were down by 3 goals. And there's no quit in our team, but it's pretty tough to score 3 goals in the last 6 or 7 minutes against a team like St. Mike's. Mm-hmm.
Mark, their power play has been pretty strong throughout the series, though in game five, you guys seemed to kind of figure it out a little bit back again tonight. Was there any adjustments they made differently that kind of figured your guys' strategy?
They're moving the puck very well and they're spreading us out. And, I looked at I have to look at the game film, the one goal in front. I thought there was interference on the goalie, but they're moving the puck very well. They're holding their position. They're just laying pucks in off pads and makes it very difficult for goaltenders. And again, you need players to be in good position, and be there to negate some of those chances. And once the game kind of slipped away, we have to take those are the six. Well, the penalty killers we've been using have been, effective enough all year. But again, we're giving up way too many opportunities, and again, it's taxing our top end guys, and they're taking advantage of that.
And obviously, you don't want to go down 4-0 ever, but in game six, what does this team have to do game six preparation wise to be better?
I believe after game one, I talked about the first period that we had, and you win a couple games in overtime, obviously it's a pretty good feeling amongst players, but this team didn't finish first overall because they didn't play a strong game and had a game plan in place, and they came out ready to play in the first period, and again we didn't have the intensity that we needed to match theirs, and again found ourselves way behind. You put yourself in a situation again, you might get a bounce here or there, maybe Shaw at the end of the second period scores on one of those opportunities, it may be a different game. But the depth of their team, the strength of their team wasn't going to allow us to get back into this one.
Thanks a lot, guys.
Thanks, guys.
There you go, Mark Reeds and Joey Hischen talking after the 7-3 loss of the Mississauga St. Michael's Majors in Game 5 of the Rogers OHL Championship Series. Majors on top in the series, 3-2. Ben Ennis joined by Michelle Storino and Peter Curtis. And let's talk a little bit about what Mark Reeds was saying. He said his team wasn't prepared. He put it on him. First period, they just weren't prepared. And, that was pretty obvious, I guess. They were down 4-0 in a heartbeat. But interesting for him to put it on himself.
Yeah, absolutely. I don't know, Peter, you were mentioning your thoughts on
the
Mark
Gilbert giveaway. That was what opened the door. The goaltender had no chance. And here's the one we talked about, kind of handcuffed him. Must have thought he was going to wait and go backhand. Take a look, a right-handed shot coming down the middle of the ice and handcuffs the goalie. And right there, I think he makes the goalie change just to inspire his team more than to say, Zador hasn't done the job.
No, it was another game of goaltending changes for the Owen Sound attack as Michael Zador gets the hook and back in is Scott Stager. And Mark Reeds was asked the question, have you decided on a starter for game six? He said he hadn't, and it will be interesting to see who he goes to, whether it's back to Zador or sticks with Stager. Stager had a pretty good second period and third period, maybe a couple of goals in the first period that he would want back. But I thought overall, Stager had a pretty good game. What'd you guys think?
5 goals on 29 shots, and I mean, majority of them were on the power play too. Yeah. So I mean,
another 4 power play goal game for the Majors.
Yeah,
ridiculous.
Absolutely. So you can't really judge his performance based on that. You can judge their special teams performance based on 4 goals on 5 opportunities. And I mean, would you actually go with possibly Jordan Binnington?
I don't know. We'll talk a little bit more about that. But first, we got the Majors press conference. Dave Cameron with Devontae Smith-Pelly.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to the post-game press conference, the Rogers OHL Championship Series. Joined now with Mississauga St. Michael's Majors head coach Dave Cameron, and tonight's first star with a hat trick, Devontae Smith-Pelly. Devontae, we'll start with you. 3 goals in probably the biggest game of the season. Just talk about your performance tonight.
I mean, all 3 of my goals were just me kind of going in the net and putting my stick on the ice, and that's what I've been doing pretty much all year and all playoffs. And playing with 2 guys like Shug and Cizikas, that's really all you have to do is go to the net and put your stick on the ice. And, you know, tonight they just pretty much put it right on my tape, and all I had to do is kind of just put it in.
Coach, for you, the team put 7 goals past the attack tonight, and you guys got the win after a couple tough losses. What's the game plan heading into Owen Sound on Thursday?
Well, we got to play our game. The game was closer than the score, but I thought, you know, we were very deserving of it. We scored 7 goals and lots of other chances. And outside of all that other crap that happened, it wasn't too bad a game.
Now take questions.
Dave, picking up on the notion of the crap, do you expect any repercussions from that going forward?
Yeah, match penalty is a suspension, and it should be. Cowardly act.
Coach, how is Chris doing?
Good.
Obviously, on that note, do you feel like they were trying to provoke you guys at all at the end of that game?
They've done a lot of BS the whole series. They're either diving or complaining. And you got a kid that's been diving the whole series, goes up and just takes the cheapest shot possible. And a comment. Oh, and one other thing, I just remembered, you got a kid that had more penalty minutes tonight than shifts. That's not usually a good sign.
Dave, McNardy's scored a goal in every game of the series. What do you guys have to do to kind of eliminate him?
I'm not sure you can eliminate him, but you have to certainly be very aware of him. And he just, you know, the playoffs bring out guys that just get on hot streaks, and he's certainly the guy that's on a real hot streak for that team. And you know, when those guys get hot, you know, you just have to make sure that you're aware of them. But, you know, some of the goals he's scoring are just pure goal scorers' goals.
Dave, 6-5, 2-1, now 7-3. It's kind of up and down all over the place. You guys are known for your great defensive prowess. Going into game 6, what do you have to do to tighten things up defensively?
Well, I hope the referees stay out of it. The referee and the score. And when games are on the line, there's calls being made that have no bearing on the play. And it's letting Owen Sound hang around. So I hope the referees stay out of it and just get back to our style of play.
Coach, going back to game 5 for a second, it was such a close one. You certainly can't fault a team for its efforts, but what sort of adjustments would you have to have made coming into tonight? Sorry, game 4 rather, on Sunday.
I'm sorry, say that again. The game we lost in Owen Sound, the last one?
Yes, exactly, yeah. Sorry.
Tonight's game?
Yep.
Two things we concentrated on was neutral zone, because they're doing a really good job of clogging up the neutral zone. I thought we had better speed through the neutral zone. And the other thing was, we fell in the game in Owen Sound. We had some chances, but we also passed up a lot of other chances in terms of holding on the puck too long at 2-on-1s and 3-on-1s, and we felt that we let the goalie off off the hook a little bit in Owen's sound, and you know, he's a good goalie. And I just thought tonight we did a real good job early of getting pucks to the net and then getting that second and third whack at it, which is how you score in the playoffs. So the neutral zone, making it hard on a goalie, were the two things we concentrated on today.
Yeah, Coach, I noticed as well a number of your goals tonight looked like the guys were shooting higher on both Owen Sound and goaltenders. Was that part of your game plan as well tonight? I didn't notice that as much in the previous games.
No, our game plan isn't to shoot high. Our game plan is to shoot low. Usually one gets you two if you do, in terms of rebound and to drive the net.
Devonta, you touched on this a little bit earlier, but your line has combined for about 60% of your team's goals so far in this series. Why have you guys been so successful?
I think it's just a lot of chemistry. We've played together pretty much the whole year. Like I said, those guys are great players, and those guys will find you no matter what. As long as, like I said, I put my stick on the ice, or Shug puts a stick on the ice, Ezekis or Shug will find you. So, they just make it easy for me to play my game, and they're great at it.
Dave, you mentioned about shooting high, your game plan and stuff. Does it matter who starts in net for them, your game plan, shooting wise?
No. The big thing being is that most teams in the playoff, and certainly Owen Sound, do a real good job of coming back to the front of the net. So that eliminates your second and third pass. And so if you get an opportunity, as long as you're driving the net, that guy driving the net is every bit as important as the guy with the puck, because the goalie sees him in his peripheral vision. And like I said, if the shot's right, you'll get your second shot off of that, and it's just like playing the odds.
Coach, you have anything planned to say to the team? You're one game away from closing them out and finally getting this championship.
No, it's the first thing we always address is to respect your opposition. So you got to go in there knowing that if you don't play your best game, you're not going to win, or you're not going to give yourself the best chance to win, or you're going to have to rely on luck to win. So it's about us, and at this time of year, we know the style of play that gives us the best chance. So it's a matter now of going in. We want to make sure over the next 2 days we get energized, make sure over the next couple of days that we have a realization that that style of play has made us successful, brings within one game, but also knowing that it's not going to be easy.
Dave, this is the last one on all this stuff at the end. You mentioned respect your opposition. You guys always address that right away. Do you feel like they're respecting you guys?
No, I think there's a lot of after whistle stuff. I think there's a lot of stuff that's not getting called. Especially when we have the lead. The refs are refereeing the score. And we go to Owen Sound the other night, and I think we had the first three power plays, and they had the next six. That says it all. Same as tonight. We scored early night a couple times in power play. They get the next four or five, and they're missing stuff, and it's frustrating.
Game six of the series shifts back to Owen Sound on Thursday. Congratulations on the win, guys. Thank you.
Thanks. Well, that was pretty tame. And that was unbelievable. Dave Cameron taking everybody to task. Referees, the Owen Sound attack, the way that game finished, and this was after a 7-3 win to move to within one game of winning the OHL championship. Dave Cameron, I'm almost speechless. You talk about the match penalty, of course, to Andrew Shaw. He was very adamant that he should be suspended, and we're not 100% sure if he will be suspended. He believes that that's an automatic suspension, getting a match penalty at the end of the game like that, but we'll have to see how that pans out. He also was asked whether the Owen Sound Attack have respect for the Mississauga St. Michael's Majors. He said no, and maybe we'll get a chance to talk about this in a little bit, but just absolutely incredible, Dave Cameron, and we'll see how the Owen Sound Attack respond after hearing what Dave Cameron said about their team and the referees. But first, let's send it upstairs to Brad and Will.
Thanks, Ben. As the fights were breaking out here at the Hershey Center, a game was getting underway at West. WHL, game number 3 of that championship series between Portland and Kootenai. What's going on so far after one period?
Well, right now, as the second period is just moments away from starting, it's 1-1 in Cranbrook, BC. Kootenai opened the scoring, but Portland answered back in the span of 2 minutes towards the end of the first period. So that's the score heading into the second there.
That's the situation there. The puck drop was at 9 o'clock at Recplex, and then Cranbrook hosts game number 2 tomorrow. Kootenai, of course, hosting game number 4 tomorrow night. Sorry, second game in as many nights in that series. QMJHL, real quickly, St. John won 5-0 last night to take a 2-1 series lead over top of Gatineau. Game 4 tomorrow night.
Yeah, that's right. St. John maybe a little slower to get off after a long 8-day rest after their semifinal series. They won game 1 2-1 and lost game 2 3-2, but they won 5-0 in that third game. So they seem to be back in top form as they should be as the number one ranked team left in the CHL. Thank you.
It's been a long night. One interesting fact we dug up, the Ice 2002, the last time they won the Memorial Cup, they're the most recent winner. The St. John, Mississauga, and the Attack, three probable Memorial Cup teams, have never been to or won a Mem Cup, so it'll be interesting to see what transpires there. And now Alicia with Dave Rukavina.
Guys, thank you very much. Dave Rukavina here with me. Guess we'll go through the Owen Sound Attacks post-game presser. First of all, head coach Mark Reeds and Joey Hishon, Colorado Avalanche draft pick, first rounder last year, basically saying they did not have the intensity that they have, especially in games 3 and 4 of this series. And Joey Hishon saying it's just too big of a hole to climb out of, being down 4-0 early in the game against a St. Mike's team who is just so strong defensively. They came close, but just couldn't get the job done.
I was very surprised in that first period the way the Attack came out. You'd have thought that they'd come out full of vim and vigor after two dramatic wins, of course, here Friday night and then an Owen Sound Sunday in overtime. But they looked very flat coming out, and you saw what happened. The Majors pounced on them for 4 goals. But then the Attack fought their way back and looked early in the third period like, we thought, maybe is overtime a game tonight? And then the Majors just turned around and took the game away from the Attack. So we'll see what happens Thursday night. Maybe the Majors win their first championship in 50 years.
Now over to the Major side of things. Head coach Dave Cameron and Devontae Smith-Pelly here. Head coach Cameron not being shy whatsoever in his feelings and emotions towards the way that the game was refereed and the way that it was played by the opposition, the Owen Sound Attack. Certainly targeting more than one player, I would say, but the good news is Chris D'Souza, aptly put, is good. He's okay, but nonetheless, it seems like there's going to be repercussions from this, not only maybe from the front office of the OHL, but between these two teams, a little bad blood on the ice for game 6.
Oh, you certainly wonder about that, Alicia, but certainly Dave Cameron did not mention Andrew Shaw, but if you watch the game, you'd know that Andrew was the target of Dave's comments. But Dave was certainly very heated after the game, and heated at his own players as well when you had that fight there right at the end of the game involving Michael D'Orazio, and I forget who it was from the Attack. But you saw him have some real sharp words for Joe Cramarosa as Joe was coming off the bench. And I think the point of Dave's words were that don't get yourself thrown out and don't make yourself, don't take yourself out of the game Thursday night, or even Sunday for that matter, should a game 7 be necessary.
Thank you very much, Alicia. And the Mississauga Majors, as you mentioned, one win away from collecting their first ever Ontario Hockey League championship. It'd be a shame not to see it here in this building, but I'm sure the Majors would take it any which way they can get it. And we just have a couple of minutes before we have to sign off here on our broadcast. Ben Ennis, Michelle Storino, Peter Curtis. I think we want to talk a little bit more about Dave Cameron's comments about the referees, saying they're reffing the score, saying he wasn't happy with Andrew Shaw taking that match penalty, didn't think his team was garnering respect from the Owen Sound Attack. I mean, what do we make of that?
Well, let's think about from Mark Reed's perspective,
yeah,
too. What is going to be the reaction when he and his team hear the no respect factor and that they think that the reffing is helping them? I don't know. You have to keep first of all, he has to keep his team disciplined in order to stay in games, because when the Mississauga St. Michael's Majors go 4-for-7 on the power play, and then, of course, all a big melee ensues at the end of periods, obviously not a good thing if you're heading home and trying to tie the series up. Peter?
Well, Devontae Pelly, Smith-Pelly, you could tell he didn't want to be there once Coach Cameron got in his rant. And you feel good and bad for the kids when they're in the middle of it, but it's setting up a great Game 6, especially with a little bit of talk after the game. It's old school hockey.
Yeah, it should be fantastic. Game 6 coming Thursday afternoon night. Thursday night in Owen Sound. They don't play in the afternoon on the weekday. But if there is a Game 7, back here Sunday afternoon at the Hershey Center. For everybody, I'm Ben Ennis. We'll see you from the Hershey Center.
Hi. I'm Bobby Gillespie, president of the Owen Sound Rotary Club. I'm here to thank our Owen Sound Attack Challenge sponsors. Their contributions make Rotary projects a reality.
Call the Rogers TV Viewer Response Line.